But right now, the final seconds winding down before we start the first period here. And, you know, Jason Kasdorf and Merrick Madsen take their positions, and we're almost ready to start.
Getting ready to go. And a big game, really, for RPI, their last league game of this fall semester. They get Arizona State for 2 years next week, but those games don't count like these do. RPI tries to maintain its position towards the top of the standings.
Yeah, right now, the coming here with an even record against Harvard, and Quinnipiac got 2 points yesterday, so it's going to be a tough battle.
Underway from the Houston Fieldhouse, it's RPI and number 8 Harvard as the Crimson have the puck in front of their own bench area. Jimmy Vesey backhands it near side. It's flipped into the offensive zone by Clay Anderson. Jason Kasdorf back between the sticks for RPI. His first appearance since November against Clarkson. He was knocked out of that game, and the engineers fired all the way down. This should be icing. And we get an early whistle just 25 seconds in.
Well, RPI needs to, last game they came out, yesterday they came out really flat against Dartmouth, and they never recovered. It took Harvard 10 seconds against Union last night to score a goal. So RPI has weathered the first 10 seconds, and it's a no score.
Faceoff coming up here. Draw to the near side of the RPI zone. Engineers went back behind their own goal. It's Parker Reno, the junior blue liner from Edina, Minnesota. Near side for Jared Wilson, sophomore from Calgary. As Moy plays into the RPI zone. Behind the net, around to the far corner. Vesey back to the point. Bergen fakes the shot, finds Vesey in the circle. Centering pass, Chris Colo, peeled away from him nicely by Liljegren. And he'll move it on out to center. And all the way down, took a deflection. No, another icing call here. So RPI's opening line that was out there is going to have to stay on the ice while the Crimson change.
And RPI again gets two icings in a row. Again, I mentioned a fast start for Harvard, but of course it's going to be it might be a different game for Harvard too. First game, Cam Hackett was in the net. Now Jason Kasdorf is in the net. And so Harvard might try to break it early.
Near point. Jaw keeps it alive in the zone. Down low to the corner. And now turning out of the corner, Esposito. Tight angle shot off the back of the net. Came off the stick of Floodstrand. Fabella still battles for him. But this is the same group out there for RPI. Jam tries side of the net. Kasdorf save. Another stop. And he pins it against the pad. That was the freshman Ryan Donato, who picked up a goal against the Engineers at Notre Dame. He was denied there by Kasdorf.
And that, that's one big difference between Cam Hackett and Jason Kasdorf. Don't get me wrong, both good goalies, but Kasdorf with a little bit better positioning and rebound control.
Draw once again to the near side of the RPI zone. Of course, the Engineers are able to change now. M&M unit out there. Win it back to the near corner. Chris Bradley, senior captain from Williamsville, New York. Can't keep it alive. Shot comes from the point. Deflects to the corner. Floodstrand out of the corner now for Donato. He cycles down low for Luke Esposito, junior from Greenwich, Connecticut. Far point now. Sherman keeps it alive all the way through to the near side where it's picked up by Miller. Miller carries on out to center, crosses the red line and dumps it in. Sherman takes a look around, near side corner of his own zone, turns back to the near side to get away from Miller, and now finds Floodstrand near side, 3-on-2 to the RPI line. Floodstrand near circle, fed towards goal, saved by Kasdorf. Puck trickles to the far side circle. Melanson moves it out on the skate. Here comes Drew Melanson on the move, 1-on-2, into the zone, backhand shot saved by Madsen, and he'll glove it there. Hold on, just about 2 minutes in here, no score, RPI and Harvard.
Yeah, great job by Drew Melanson on the rush back up the ice in transition after the huge save by Kasdorf. And Harvard can match RPI's speed. Dartmouth couldn't. So Dartmouth was a good forechecking team yesterday, frustrated RPI. Now they have to match up with the speed of Harvard.
Draw here in the Harvard zone, one to the middle of the ice. Wood has it poked away from him to the far side, taking over with it, Bourbonnais. Bourbonnais, near side Moore, wrist shot, pad save made. Right pad stop. By Madsen, and now breaking out towards center ice. Schrader broke it up on the way, but the Crimson carry on. They'll flip to the near corner. Having to stop there was the centerman, Sean Malone. Did not play against RPI first time out. A backhand pass by Bourbonnais. Probably a poor decision, but it popped right to Moore. And Blond kind of backhand pass across the middle of the ice. The Engineers need to be on top of their game here against the Crimson, who beat them 4-0 last Saturday. Bourbonnais shoots it into the Harvard zone. Turning with it there, Jacob Olson, freshman from St. Paul, Minnesota. Down the middle, Shot coming from Ellis, saved by Kasdorf, but just sat there. He'll cover left side of his crease. He gets a whistle.
Yeah, this is going to be a more wide-open game every period. We've seen it. We've seen it now, 17-11 left to play in the first, no score, RPI and Harvard. Very wide-open game. Both teams great in transition. Both goalies going to be on, both goalies going to be have to be on top of their game as well. So it's going to be an exciting game here at the Fieldhouse.
Merrick Madsen came into the weekend with a .60 goals against average. But he gave up four goals to Union last night in Schenectady. So finally he's been cracked, as they say. Unable to do so at any point so far previously. Ellis in the near corner now. Hands it off there to Zerder Gossage. Wraps around to the far side. Bergen pinching in. He gets hit by Nanny. Played behind the RPI goal to Mike Prapavesis. Picked up assist number 9 last night. His team-leading 9th assist on the lone RPI goal. This will travel all the way down the ice after it came off of Nanny's stick. It'll be icing on the engineer. Shots are 5-2 Harvard early in a scoreless game.
Yeah, you know, both goalies really have to make some good saves. Madsen had to make one point blank on Mears Moore. And Jason Kasdorf on the other end has made four quality ones. So 16:44 left to play in the first, no score.
Draw here to the left of Jason Kasdorf. Senior netminder from Winnipeg, Manitoba, 3-4-0 on the season. 2.46 goals against and a .927 save percentage. Nanny will carry it out to center ice, cross center and dump it in. And now skating behind his own goal is Braden Jaw, picking up speed to the neutral zone. Jaw all the way to the RPI zone, to the far circle, trickling in on Kasdorf, and he'll cover. Waiting on the doorstep was Tyler Moy, the junior out of San Diego.
Actually, not bad positioning by the engineer defender. That was actually Victor Liljugren back defending. Good positioning, went off his skate harmlessly, and Jason Kasdorf covered up. 16:25, left to play in the first, no score.
Draw coming up here, this time to the right of Kasdorf. It'll be Babella up against Kyle Criscolo. And dragging it out in front of the net. A backhand shot went wide off the stick of Vizi. Poking at it, Liljegren. In deep now, near corner. Jimmy Vizi spins away from Babella. Trying to walk it to the far side. A shot. Moy save. Rebound, Criscolo trying to jab it in on the far side. And Moy peels it away to the far side circle. Turning and shooting. Another save by Kasdorf. And he'll hold on there. A tight angle shot there from Tyler Moy. And Kasdorf has had to be sharp early in this game.
Excellent job by Jason Kasdorf. It doesn't show any rust of just coming back from injury, staying calm and controlling the play, covering the puck when he needs to cover it up. 16:04 left to play in the first, no score.
Draw coming, Crimson win it back to the point, far side. Firing through a screen, it hit Schrader, never got to goal. Around to the far side, Wood turns it back towards his own man, Schrader, who wasn't ready for it. Moore picks it up in the near side corner, flips it all the way down the ice. Will it have the legs for icing is the question. Yes, another icing call here on RPI. A little bit back in their own end, back on their heels are the engineers to start this game.
Yeah, and, you know, they came out flat in the first period, and, you know, they came out with more energy now, but they really can't seem to solve the Harvard rush.
Face off once again in the RPI zone, 15:44 to play in the first period. Newell, a slapper, bounces on in, wide of goal. Never got there, in fact, and now will be picked up by Wood and skated out to center, chipped off the boards for Bourbonnais. Riley Bourbonnais, the junior from Rochester, in the corner. We get a whistle here. And I'm not sure quite what for. I still don't know. We're going to get a center ice face-off out of it.
Yeah. The only thing I can think of, maybe inadvertent whistle. I mean, Bourbonnais was not offsides. The puck was not out of play. And the face-off's going to come neutral zone. Unfortunate for RPI on that.
Shots are 8-2 Harvard. Still early on in the first period. Scoreless game. Fulton in there to take the face-off. This is the first look we have at the RPI fourth line. Tonight, it's Lonnie Clary making his 8th appearance. Freshman in there from Riverside, California. So a couple Californians in this one. Jesper Orval, not from California. In fact, he's from Sweden. Lost the puck at his own blue line. Horton moves in. Takes a hit from Clary. Horton a shot. Pad saved by Kasdorf. Goes behind the goal. Fulton up the near boards. Kept in. Deflected on goal. And a save by Kasdorf. He denied Malone on a wicked deflection in front of the cage.
Yeah, and Kasdorf just got a piece of that with his outer thigh, it looked like, as he was trying to go down in the butterfly and play the puck. It was just a bang, bang situation, and he didn't see it, but he saved it. 14-47 left to play in the first. No score. RPI and Harvard shots 10-2 right now in favor of the Crimson.
Draw coming up here in the RPI zone. Scoreless game. Near side, a bit of a delay. Here we go. Schrader lost it. Jaw faked his shot. He'll elect to just slide it below the goal line. Goes behind the goal. Picked up there by Zerder Gossage. Louis Zerder Gossage, freshman from Montreal. Has it poked away from him by Prapovesis, and they move it up the near side boards to center. Wood trying to feed it in the middle of the ice. It'll be gloved down by Zerder Gossage. Fed far side, shot comes in on goal, saved by Kasdorf, helps it to the near side, Jaw picks up, takes a shot, deflects wide, picked up by Schrader, engineers want to go, three engineers ahead, here's Bourbonnais, onside, in, Bourbonnais, save made by Madsen, behind the goal for Wood, Wood holding, feeds to the far side, Hampton, down low, finding Wood, Wood, fed to the center blue line, Schrader, far circle for Hampton, wrist shot, glove save, Madsen, and he holds on. The engineers with a little bit of fight back here midway through this period.
Yeah.
They turned into a great chance.
RPI on their heels, letting Jason Kasdorf make the saves, and when they do, RPI great in transition, having a 3-on-1. Bourbonnais with a great shot, it just handcuffed Madsen. Madsen made the save, but RPI gets it back on the run, and he holds on. 14-08 left to play in the first. No score. RPI and Harvard. RPI had their best chance of the game.
Draw coming here to the left of Merrick Madsen, the sophomore from Acton, California. As it's picked up in the far circle by Milos Babela. Turning. Backhand save. And the puck isn't covered. And the whistle goes to the defense of the referee on the near side. I believe that's Peter Fiola. It is. The puck was on the other side of the goaltender, and he couldn't see it. Bit of a quick whistle, but the Crimson will take it there.
A bit of a quick whistle. I believe it got stuck in Madsen's pads, and the whistle blew. Then it was like a bang-bang thing. So I don't know if that was an early whistle, but the whistle blew, and the puck came loose. 14-01 left to play in the first. No score.
Babela, a rising shot over the top of the net. Comes free to the near point. Kept in by Wilson, who slams it off the back wall. Loose at the side of the cage. Rodriguez trying to jump on it. And went down. It'll be played up the wall. Wilson one-hands it back out to center. Moy shoots it right back into the RPI zone. Vizi trying to track it down. First one to it, Wilson. Behind far side for Babela. And now scooped in the air. And out to center ice by Parker Reno. Newell, near side for Vizi. He just lets it run in for Moy. Moy turning in the near circle. Fed back in front, intercepted Babela. Nearly pried away Chris Colo. Fed right in front, and it's missed by Vizi. He won't miss too many of those, but he fanned on the shot. Might have been a bouncing puck. And now it's poked free, and Kasdorf will cover. And now Vizi gets into it there with Wilson. And now Wilson takes one up high from Moy. And they'll need to be separated here.
Yeah, and that was actually Jared Wilson just trying to protect Jason Kasdorf, who puck took an odd bounce off the boards. Kasdorf came out to play, and Jared Wilson was right there just to make sure nothing happened. Moy did not like that, and he just gave a little shove to Wilson. No call. 13-17 left to play in the first. No score.
Draw coming to the far side of the RPI zone. Harvard wins it. Shot coming wide of the net. Played back behind the goal by the goal stick of Kasdorf. Hampton up the far wall. Intercepted there. Kept in by Floodstrand. And now off the boards, it's Donato. Esposito centering in front. It was knocked away from Floodstrand. He picks it up along the near boards. Shooting it right back into the RPI zone. Battling for it there. At Hampton got through him. Donato spins around in the corner. Trying to get away from Moore now. Leaves it for Esposito. Good cycling from this second unit for the Crimson. Back to the point. Shot by Bergen. Pad saved by Kasdorf. Kicked it to the far corner. Lost stick down there is Donato's. Puck in deep now. Miller has his man Esposito pinned against the corner boards along the far side. Moore helps out. Floodstrand back to the point, but nobody home. Out to center. First one, two, it is Anderson in his own zone. Lots of pressure coming with speed. It's Melanson. They've dumped him in the corner there. Fans applaud, but Donato has it back out to center ice. Clay Anderson crossing center. He'll ring it in. Behind the goal it goes for Prapovesis of RPI. Near side for Fulton. Fulton takes a look up ice, a little saucer pass ahead for Bradley. Down the middle for Orval. Orval tried to make a move on Jaw, but he says no and breaks it up. Back to the near side neutral zone. Nobody wants it. Fulton back to pick it up. Travis was not in the lineup yesterday as the engineers shoot it all the way down. Will this be icing? Yes, it will be. Not quite across the red line for the engineers. 11:54 to go in a scoreless first. It's no score.
Yeah, this is a very entertaining period so far. It's picked up a lot, RPI. Still on their heels defensively when Harvard's in the attacking zone, but RPI weathering the storm. Kasdorf doing a great job back there, and RPI in the transition game trying to make something going, but Madsen has been up to the task.
RPI played the Crimson pretty even. Last time out was a 1-0 lead for Harvard after one. Then they scored three goals in the second. There's a shot by Lloyd that trickles wide right off the faceoff. Fulton chips off the boards out to center. Shot right back in by Wiley Sherman. And now out to center. The engineers move it quickly. Bradley for Fulton. And now far side, Lonnie Clary plays it through the legs of the defender. And it's nearly cleared out by Madsen. There's a player dumped behind the goal. It was Fulton away from the puck. We play on here. Reno ahead for Fulton, who just taps it down low. And it'll be picked up by Madsen. Left for Sherman, and now Jaw. Thrown off the glass by Malone, out to center. Engineers regather at their own line. Wilson, far side for Reno. Down the middle, Schrader. He'll chip into the corner and chase. First one to it, Jaw. He gets crushed by a couple engineers there. And it's the Crimson who come out to center. This may be a 2-on-1. As Reno and his man go down, shot coming over the top of the net.
And it was touched with the high stick, too, because we got a whistle and the referee signaling a high stick. So I think this is going to come out of the zone. But on the other end, Jaw, fans wanted an interference. I agree with them. Then on the other end, Jaw just got pounded by Schrader and Bourbonnais. He got dumped. He was slow to get up, so 10:56 left to play in the first. RPI and Harvard, no score. This one getting a little chippy.
Yeah, there's a Mighty Ducks type of a Bash Brothers hit behind the goal. Two players colliding with Jaw. But we're back to action here. Puck in the far corner. Tringale to the point. Near point, Newell takes the slapper. It's blocked by Bourbonnais. Bourbonnais may have broken his stick. It's knocked out of his hand anyway. Wraparound try. That one's denied. Picked up by Schrader at the side of the cage. He'll skate behind into the far corner. High off the glass to center ice. Skips all the way down. They're going to say this is going to be icing on RPI again. Fans don't like it. They thought it might have hit Jacob Olsen over there. But they say no. Another icing on RPI here.
Yeah, I thought it did too, but you know, like I said, I had the same angles as students had, but the referee was right in front of it. Just looked like it bounced over his stick a little bit. 10:26 left to play in the first. No score, RPI and Harvard. And what has been so far an entertaining game.
Bergen carries it. Center of the slot. Save Kasdorf. Rebound fell to the ice, but not much longer. Kasdorf is able to cover it up.
And then Kasdorf doing a good job controlling the rebound and not letting Harvard Harvard crashing the net, but not letting the rebound fall in front of him and letting the Harvard forwards get it from him. So Jason Kasdorf up to the task so far. 10:20 left to play in the first. No score.
Draw here. Engineers win it. Wilson behind his own goal for Reno. Reno fanned on the outlet pass. Gets run into by Moy, and then Moy takes the puck away. Behind the goal, Chris Colo turning. Back towards Anderson. Keeps it in. Flipped to the near side of the RPI zone and played back behind by Wilson. Alex Rodriguez back to pick it up for RPI. Trying to chip out to center, gets it past Vesey, but it's picked up by Bergen, and now near side neutral zone Anderson. Back to Bergen. Desmond Bergen, senior from Natick, Mass. Turned right around by Liljegren. Tries to turn on the afterburners. Breakaway for Liljegren. Off the post and out! A drive by Rodriguez into the netting, and that puck inches away from giving RPI the lead. It hit the inside of the left post. It went all the way across the net and out.
Well, two defenders for Harvard fell down. They were trying to pinch in to stop Liljegren from getting that puck, and they sort of ran into each other on the blue line. And Liljegren made a great move to turn on the afterburners, and he just beat Madsen. The problem is he didn't beat the post. 9:40 left to play in the first, no score.
Defensive zone faceoff win for the Crimson. They move it out towards center. Into the attacking zone is Donato. Shot high in the air, up into the netting. We'll have a stoppage here.
So, after an exciting opportunity for RPI to go up 1-0 by Victor Liljegren that was denied by the post. RPI comes back and they get an icing in their own zone. 9:28 left to play in the first, no score.
Draw coming far side of the RPI zone. Played behind for Bradley. Near side, neutral zone. Look ahead pass from Melanson all the way down. No, wave it off, excuse me. That makes Sherman play it. Up the far boards, broken up by Miller. Miller looking to cycle. He's getting jabbed at by Sherman, and finally the puck comes free. Floodstrand moves it to center. He'll chip it off the near boards and all the way down. Prapovesis run into by Donato. Stays on the puck and then goes down, does Mike Prapovesis. Now a shot, Esposito, blocked by a skate in front of the goal. Caroms around to the far corner. Donato bracing for the hit from Bradley, doesn't come. Miller throws a body into his man. That is Floodstrand. Continuing to battle away in the far corner of the RPI zone. 8:37 to go in a scoreless first period. Prapovesis off the wall for Bradley. Ahead for Melanson, he's out to center. Melanson crossing center, fires it in high over the net, but it's going to be gloved by Madsen, and he'll hold on to it there.
Yeah, Madsen is sensing trouble and an RPI forward crashing the net. He just held on to the puck, and he says, I'll take my chances with a faceoff in my own zone. So he's settling this one down a little bit as RPI is starting to get a little bit of momentum. 8:28 left to play in the first, no score.
Draw coming here near side of the Harvard zone. Fulton tried to win it back. It's popped to the corner. Anderson around behind for Bergen. Far boards connection. Here they come out to center Malone for Horton. A little bit of room to work near circle. Now it's a 2-on-1. Shot coming. It's turned away by Kasdor. I don't know how he kept it out. He must have got that right pad over. I also don't know how that turned into a 2-on-1 just like that. Oh, looking at it again, he kind of scuffed the shot. It was Malone.
Yeah, Malone sort of scuffed the shot. The same thing happened to RPI. Defenders fell down on the blue line, turning it into a 2-on-1.
Kasdor, I didn't think he got over it that quickly, and he didn't need to because Malone's shot didn't have much on it. Shot in by Schrader off the back of the net, picked up by Bourbonnais behind the cage, looking to center, right in front off of Schrader, and that one leaves the zone. Offside is the call on Wilson. Oh boy, this is awful.
That is a bad, bad call. Jared Wilson had that puck. That puck didn't even touch the blue line, and they're calling that offside.
No. The fact that it's intentional is my problem.
I didn't even know if that was offside.
No, it came across the line, but there's no way it was intentional.
Okay, from my angle, it looked like it didn't even come across. So I apologize to the referee.
I don't, because that should not have been intentional offside. That's unbelievable. Jaw. Far side, Sherman. That one's blocked. Schrader off the boards. Kept in again by Sherman. I don't want to give him too much credit, but this is a pretty knowledgeable crowd. And I think everyone that realized that they were calling intentional offside for that play jumped up and were not happy about it. But it seems to have not mattered as the puck came out of play, and we'll have a neutral ice draw now. 7:43 to go in the first period. No score here between RPI and number 8 Harvard. This is tipped along by Bourbonnais, but will be icing if it's wide of the Harvard goal, and it will be another icing call. I believe they're up to 5 icings here in this first period. Still 7:35 left.
Yeah, and
not keeping score at all.
A lot of whistles, a lot of icings, a lot of when there's no whistles, it's a very entertaining game between the the boards. And RPI and Harvard, two speed teams, and showing it off today.
Puck behind the RPI goal. Moy jumps on it, trying to center. Comes all the way back to the far point. Olsen rips one off of a leg. Comes free to the near side for Newell. Victor Newell down low. Taking a hit there. Puck comes free to the near side. Bourbonnais battling for it there. Chris Colo behind the net. Spins to get away. He'll feed it to the far side. Moy's going to pick it up in the circle. Moy turning. Waiting. Spins back to the circle again. To the hash marks. Now the goal line extended down low. One-handing at Moy. He's being hooked there by Schrader. No arms go up. And we play on. Chris Colo far side. Back to the point. Near side Newell. Lots of room to drive. High and wide. And Kasdorf didn't see it at all. Another shot. This one goes well wide off the back of the cage. Is resting on the back of the net. Poked free by Schrader. Lots of offensive possession time here. Stick knocked out of the hands of Chris Colo by Wood, and the Engineers move it out to center. They're really letting him play here. Thought Schrader may have gotten away with a hook earlier. And now right down the ice is tipped in deep by Esposito. Parkerino back to pick it up for RPI. Turns to the corner. Up the wall, Pravovesis, or make it Clary, rather. Let me try one more time. Rodriguez off his skate. And it's back to Anderson. Cross-ice feed. Floodstrand far side into the zone. Esposito firing high. Saved by Kasdorf on a tight angle shot. Rodriguez trying to move that loose stick to the corner where it can't be in the way. It's picked up by Reno behind the cage. He feeds it right back behind the goal. Milos Babela has time and space now on the far side. If he can get around that loose stick, he can. Carrying out to center. Milos Babela still on the move. Still Babela down low off the back of the cage. Babela now one-hands it to the near corner. Babela all the way around, poked off his stick, and carried out to center by Donato. Ryan Donato, the Boston Bruins pick, right on in. Donato a save, trickles wide, and we get a whistle here as the net came off. 5:46 left in the first, still no score.
And you said it, Perry, the referees letting them get away with this one, letting both teams get away with a lot of penalties in this game, or would-be penalties. I thought Harvard got away with a trip against an Engineer. I thought Schrader got away with the hook. You know, I thought Wood got away with the slash that caused Cascola's stick to go up in the air. So, very, very liberally reffed game here at the Houston Fieldhouse. 5:46 left to play in the first. No score, RPI and Harvard.
Draw coming here near side of the RPI zone. Malone on the faceoff for Harvard, wins it back. Bergen, near side for Anderson. Rister on goal, save Kasdorf. Rebound poked to the crease, but it's swatted out of there, kept in Bergen. To the far side circle. Back to Bergen, center blue line, just kept it in. He'll feed it wide of goal, hits a body and trickles to the near corner. Babela, up the near boards. Can't get it out, pinching in Anderson. And it's turning and shooting with Seb Lloyd. RPI still can't clear the zone. Liljegren back to the near circle. One-handed across, poke free, and the Engineers finally move it to center. It's Alex Rodriguez all by himself. He'll chip it into the corner and then throw his shoulder into Horton before going off on a change. Coming up on 5 minutes to go in this first period. Shot into the RPI zone. It'll roll around to the near corner. Chris Bradley takes a look around. Malone is coming. He plays it up the boards for Melanson. Melanson's run into by Zerder Gossage. Taken away, walked out in front. Kasdorf made the stop. It was Stefan Tringale, the junior from Medford, Mass, who was trying to drive the net and lost the puck on the way in.
Yeah, Tringale trying to get it to his forehand on that one, and he lost the puck, and it just harmlessly trickled in on Jason Kasdorf, who covered up. 4:50 left to play in the first. No score, RPI and Harvard, and both teams putting on a show in this one.
Puck around to the far side. Picked up by Ellis. Got lost in some skates behind the cage. And now picked up again in the corner. Tringale gets rubbed off the puck there by Miller. Miller and Tringale get to go after it again. Tringale comes off the boards with the puck. Miller pokes it free once more. Now Tringale behind the cage. A couple more players join the scrum, including Chris Bradley. It's poke free off the stick of Ellis to the near corner. Really battling in this near corner of the RPI zone. Finally comes free to the point and out to center. Jaw flips it right back into the RPI zone. Pravovesis uses his body to shield, played by Nanny. Nearly ran into Vizi. And the Crimson get it deep once more. Wrong out to center for Bourbonnais. Schrader tried to chop it into the zone. It got as far as Newell. He'll go D-to-D with it. And it's carried out by Olsen. Olsen up the far side boards for Moy. Has Chris Colo in the middle. Vizi trailing. To the far corner he goes, rubbed up by Schrader. Popped in the air to the half wall. And now shot near side by Wood out of the zone. Trying to jump on it, Bourbonnais. Newell gets there first and plays it across for Olsen. Olsen down the middle for Chris Colo. Knocked away from him. Chris Colo gets back on it. Carries in near side, far circle. Backhand shot. Easy pad stop. Kick to the near corner. Back behind the goal it goes. Parkerino trying to get there. Moy right on his trail. And it's kicked up the wall for Chris Colo. Back to the point. Olsen holding. He just feeds it wide of the cage. Swatted back out towards the point. There's an Engineer there. It's Wood. And he'll hand it off for Bradley. Bradley, far side circle of his own zone. Chips it off the glass out to center. Right through Floodstrand. Picked up Olsen. 2:58 to go in a scoreless first period. RPI and Harvard from the Houston Fieldhouse. ECAC hockey here on WRPI as it's shot in by Liljegren. Olsen will try the far side. Babella's going to pick it off. Babella, far side circle, takes a hit, jumps back on the puck behind the goal. Babella turning, fed it across, and it went through the top of the crease, and no one got a stick on it. Towards the near point, kept in Rodriguez. Knocked out of the air by Esposito, and the Engineers will have to restart at center. Hampton, after his line mates and teammates touch up, shoots it in. It rattles around to the near side, comes off the dasher behind the goal. Liljen looking to shield the puck there. He gets taken down by Olsen, and now Rodriguez better be careful on the far side as he started mixing it up with Esposito and Donato.
Yeah, Rodriguez taking a little exception to the hit behind the goal, and we're going to get a holding call against the Crimson. 2:23 left to play in the first. No score, RPI and Harvard. So far on the power play, RPI 7-53, which is 13.2%. And on the penalty kill, Harvard is 26-30, which is 86.7%. So we'll get a chance to see what RPI can do on the power play with 2:23 remaining in the first.
Puck pushed to the far corner. Our Engineers on the power play as it's fed to the near side. Hampton down low to the corner. Hits off the skate of the referee. Comes free to the near point for Moore. His cross-ice saucer pass swatted at by Wood. That'll allow the Crimson to clear as Vesey jumps on it. It hits someone in the Harvard bench, and now we're going to get a face-off in the Harvard zone. So a little bit of poor puck luck there for Harvard as the face-off will come right back down their end.
Yeah, Olsen in the penalty box for Harvard. That on the hold behind the net, Jacob Olsen, a freshman out of St. Paul, Minnesota.
Puck one to the far corner. Big time pile up there. Comes free to Moore. Moore has space. Fanned on the shot. It's poked out to center. Race for the puck. Who's going to get there? Hampton looks like he has a step and does. Moy jumps on it, however. Takes a slap shot that's way high and wide. It caroms all the way out to the Harvard blue line. And they'll go D-to-D with it to Anderson. That one picked off by Schrader. He'll turn back towards his own end and give it off for Hampton. Harvard changing half of its penalty kill unit. Hampton walking in. Centering pass in the air. Tips to the far side. Schrader there. Down low. Bourbonnais. Far side half wall to the point for Wilson. Takes a shot. Skips just wide. Picked up by Anderson. He'll try to clear out near side. Hampton on his tape in the air to the near corner. It'll stay on the ice. Dumped in the corner. Penalty coming up here. They're going to get Clay Anderson. He drilled Schrader from behind. And it's going to be 54 seconds of 5-on-3 time for the Engineers.
It's going to be a cross check against Clay Anderson. 54 seconds of 5-on-3 time for RPI. It was kept in nicely there by Hampton, who was trying to play, and Clay Anderson just said, I want that puck, and I don't care how I'm going to get it, but unfortunately it happened right in front of the referee. So 1:17 left to play in the first here on this one. 54 seconds left in Olsen's penalty, and 2 minutes left on Olsen's penalty, resulting in a 5-on-3 for RPI. So good chance for RPI to get some goals here in the first period, with the tail end of the first period, to try to get some momentum going into the break.
You say goals. I think the Engineers will take one here. Face off. One back to Hampton. Far side Wilson. Back to Hampton. One-timer block. Rebound loose in the slot. And it's cleared as far as Hampton at the near point. Far point Wilson. Down low Bourbonnais. He'll carry it back up to the top. Near side circle Hampton. Down low Babella. Fed through the crease. And a chance for Jaw to maybe clear. Near side Hampton. He'll stop it there and slow it down. Good patient play by the senior Phil Hampton. Bourbonnais down the middle, shot goes wide, picked up Babella on the skate, taps it to the point. Hampton trying to feed it back to Babella. He does. Still another 20 seconds to go in the 5-on-3, and the pass leaves the zone all the way out. Stop there by Kasdorf. Maybe one more rush here on the 5-on-3. 10 seconds left on it as the Engineers move it to center. Wilson carries into the RPI zone. He'll flip it in. Penalty about to expire to Olsen. Still another minute 5 on the RPI power play. As Olsen is out, Wilson has it along the boards. Up the wall, Bergen clears. Stop behind the net by Kasdorf. 10 seconds to go in the period. This will carry over a near giveaway in their own zone, although it's picked up by Prapovesis. Fed far side for Melanson. 2 seconds to go in the period. Melanson walking in on the backhand. He'll stop and turn and won't get a shot away. And that will do it for the first period. RPI and Harvard skate to a scoreless tie after one. Shots are 20-7 on the board in favor of Harvard. Although by the end of the period, things seemed to level off a little bit as far as the chances were concerned.
Yeah, and I think that on a 5-on-3, it cleared the zone. There was a little bit of a confusion on RPI's part as Bubella thought the defender was going to pinch down for the puck. Bubella thought the defender was going to stay on the blue line for the puck, so he passed it out. Meanwhile, the defender pinched down, and that resulted in the puck going out of the zone. So a little bit of confusion. RPI had a 5-on-3. They still start the second period with a 5-on-4 power play for a little over a minute. And good, entertaining period. Both goalies up to the task. Especially Jason Kazdorf tested coming off the injury early, the first game back since the injury. So he's tested a lot, tested often, and he, so far he's been up to the task.
Absolutely. We'll have a couple of intermissions to bring you. We'll have, I believe,
second intermission.
Will be Dr. Lee McElroy, RPI Athletic Director. Ed will have Lee here live for you at the RPI Houston Fieldhouse press box. We'll have our first intermission coming up in just a couple minutes. Once again, your score after one period is RPI nothing and number 8 Harvard nothing. You're listening to live coverage of RPI Hockey on 91.5 FM WRPI Troy.
Is dedicated to preserving traditional forms of dance music across campus and the community. The team incorporates several forms, including Kuchipudi and Cat Pack. RPI Sangam acts as a forum for students who are interested in the practice of these forms of art and for the preservation and modern evolution of such classical art forms. Please welcome Sangam. Thank you. Sandgam. Hey, stop by the Engineers Pro Shop, now located across from the concession stand behind Section 2. They offer dry fits, fitted hats, pint glasses, game pucks, and more. Stop by and check it all out between periods. Ryan Zwake is proud to support RPI Athletics. After the game, head downtown and check out the pub kitchen at Ryan Zwake.
Thank you.
RPI Men's Hockey would like to thank GE, Mohs, SEFQ, CDPHP, The Rock, Boucher and Clark Financial Group, Jenny, Montgomery Scott, Price Chopper, AFSCO Fence, Yankee Trails, Red Front Pizza, Tri-City Rentals, Dunkin' Donuts, Toyota, Ben & Jerry's, Warren W. Fane, and Tri-City Valley Cats, all proud sponsors of RPI Hockey. Elsewhere in the ECAC, one final this afternoon, it was Quinnipiac 3, Brown 0. After one, Cornell 2, Clarkson 1. Also at the end of one at St. Lawrence, 2, Colgate 0. Early in the second, Princeton 2, Yale 0. And middle of the first, it's Union 2, Dartmouth 0.
Thanks, Seth. As a former captain of the RPI hockey team and a proud member of the RPI athletic family, I'm proud to call the Capital Region my home. For the past 30 years, I've raised my family here and built my business around providing sound financial advice to my clients. My firm is fiercely independent and highly dedicated to earning the trust and confidence of our clients every day. I welcome the opportunity to show you how we can protect and enhance your wealth today. Please call me for a free consultation. And let's go Red!
Ed DeGaren along with Perry Lascaris here on your call for Engineering Hockey, 91.5 FM WRPI Troy. Before we get started with the second period of play, we'd like to thank the Rensselaer Union, which provided funding for WRPI and all club-related activity of the Institute, including WRPI's coverage of RPI men's and women's ice hockey, football, and baseball. Also like to remind you, WRPI is on the World Wide Web. Point your browser to www.wrpi.org. And you can hear our broadcast 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, so long as WRPI is broadcasting. We will provide the broadcast on our internet feed once again. And that is www.wrpi.org.
Getting ready for period number two here. No score. Jason Kansdorf with 20 first period saves. The Engineers earlier this year and defeated then number one Boston College 2-1. Jason Kansdorf was in net for that game. And they needed that kind of effort from him throughout the entire game in order to pick up that win.
Yeah, and let's not mention the defense on that too.
Right, of course. They put a block, 46, 27 shots. Right.
Sort of got away from that a little bit, but you know that's what they need to do. RPI starts 43 seconds on the power play for this one.
Ready to drop the puck here on period number two. It'll be Bourbonnais and Jimmy Vesey. Vesey doesn't take a lot of faceoffs for this Harvard club. But he's out there now. And it's one back to Mears Moore. Near side for Hampton. Skate to center, feed it ahead. Wood, he'll ring it in from the near side around to the far corner. Played behind the cage. Wood trying to move it back to the point. Fanned on the pass. He gets dumped there by Sherman. And it's fired all the way down. Into the corner where it deadens there. Moore picks it up. Nearly taken away there by Criscolo. Vesey digs for it. Now he'll back off. Wood takes it out of the pile with 9 seconds to go on the power play. Engineers race it to center 3-on-3 with a man trailing. Bourbonnais cross ice in the air. Not much that Trader could do with it besides knock it down. He did a good job to do just that. Penalty about to expire. Out of the box comes Anderson. And it's cleared all the way down. This will be on goal. So Kansdorf will cover. And he gets sprayed neatly and rather nicely by Anderson.
Yeah, Anderson was going to make the change as he came out of the box, but the puck got rifled down. So he figured he might as well go in and sort of give Kansdorf a little snow for his efforts. 19:08 left to play in the second. No score.
Faceoff coming in the RPI zone. It'll be Miller against Esposito. Here's Miller. Skates behind his own goal with it. And stolen away, Donato. Toe drag to the backhand, put it wide. Engineers cannot give the puck away in their own end like that. That time Donato did not make them pay. Floodstrand in there dueling with Bradley and Miller with Donato. And now they're going to get a penalty out of this. It's going to be a tripping call on Miller. And it's one of those plays where guys are battling for the puck. Legs and sticks are all intertwined. I really don't think there should ever be a penalty given in such a situation. You know, this one happens to be against RPI, but it's just an odd call, especially in that circumstance.
Yeah, they were battling the puck. I think what happened is the Harvard forward was down and Mark Miller sort of went through him instead of around him, and that resulted in the penalty 41. I think if Mark Miller went around him, he wouldn't have got the penalty. 8:41 left to play in the second, no score.
You're probably right on that, as it's one back to the point. Newell, near side for VZ. Back to Newell. Fanned on the one-timer. Thought he might have broken his stick, but he's still out there. Newell now. Near circle for VZ. Deflected wide of goal. It was Chris Colo just trying to steer it into the net. It missed, and the Engineers cleared out to center. Bouncing puck played by Newell far side. Malone carries in. Losing his stick and going down was VZ. He'll go back and pick up his stick. Meanwhile, Malone carries to the near side circle. Down low. Glove down. Moy for VZ. Back to the point. Newell. Far side circle Malone. Holding it there. Center blue line. It's Newell. Stick handling. Rabella right in front of him. Malone now. Top of the far circle. Near side for VZ. Jimmy VZ. 7 goals and 7 assists. And there's a drive. Blocked away. Excuse me. 8 goals, 8 assists now for VZ. Had 1-1 yesterday against Union. As it's tapped around to the far side half wall. Malone back down low. Helped to the near side wall by Wilson and cleared to center by Bobella. 52 seconds to go on the Harvard power play. It's first of the game. No score here. 2.5 into the second period between RPI and the 8th-ranked Crimson. VZ still out there. He has been for the entire power play thus far. It is knocked free from Newell. Nanny thought about trying to track down that loose puck. Couldn't quite get there. This one skips by Bradley and all the way down. Kasdorf's going to leave it. Because the Harvard side is changing as Nanny stops behind him, or excuse me, in front of his own bench. He just plays it into the Harvard zone. They'll start out from behind their own net now, will the Crimson. And into RPI territory. Near side it goes. Now below the goal line, Esposito to the near corner. Fans counting down on that power play, which is now over. Jake Wood around to the corner. He'll leave it behind the goal for Bradley. He gets roughed up a bit. Esposito, centering pass, deflected on goal. Picked up and turning and shooting. Donato looking behind him was Kasdorf, but he's got it in there somewhere. He made another save. 16:28 to play in the second. No score here.
Yeah, a lot of traffic with Jason Kasdorf looking behind him to make sure he had that puck. And he did. He had it safely, securely in his padding. 16:28 left to go in the second. RPI and Harvard still scoreless.
Draw here in the RPI zone. Shot around to the far side. Melanson has a man breaking. It was Orval. And it'll be picked up by Sherman. Skates back to his own zone. Orval pressuring. Knocked it away. Tie up along the near wall. Harvard zone. Zerter Gossage was tied up. Puck comes out to center. I'm not sure if I've got Zerter Gossage right either the last two games. Someday, maybe. Sherman, near side of his own end, spins away from the poke check of Melanson and gives it back to Jaw. Now Sherman from behind his own goal. Harvard very patient here, looking to set up the breakout. Down the middle they go to Zerter Gossage. Up the far side boards into RPI territory. Hampton off the boards. Picked up by Liljegren. Poked away by Ellis. Turning is Zerter Gossage. Fed it through the top of the crease and all the way through. Near side now Orval. Turning. Throws it up ice for Liljegren. Liljegren trying to take the puck away from Newell. As it comes bouncing back in the center ice, skips by Fulton, backhanded into the RPI zone by Olsen. Turned around by Prapovesis, fed up the wall, ahead for Miller. Miller makes a move around Newell. No, Newell knocked him into the boards, puck came free. Moy now behind the goal. He takes a hit from Clary for Vesey near side. He lost the handle on it, out to center. Bradley touches it on further. Vesey takes it off the wall, ahead for Criscolo. Criscolo for Vesey, wrist shot coming, and Kasdorf makes the glove save.
Yeah, Jimmy Vesey, a common name when you mention candidates for Hobie Baker. Jimmy Vesey's name is one of the first three off your mouth. He's that good of a player. 14:50 left to play. Jason Kasdorf could have been there too, but he got hurt, so he has a long way to hold to dig out of. No score, RPI and Harvard, 14:50 left to play in the second.
Draw coming here, far side of the RPI zone. Shot off the draw was blocked, picked up by Reno. Reno tied up now with Moy. Coming away with it, Miller for a second, stolen away by Vesey. Comes free to the point from Newell. He can't find it. A chance to break. Melanson walking in on the shot, and he put it off the pad. Rebound off the side of the cage from Nanny. Melanson back to the point and by Reno. Now Vesey trying to break the other way. Vesey turns around in the near circle. Back to the point he goes. Cross ice feed. Lots of room for Horton to drive. Rebound swing and a miss by Moy, and it trickles to the near corner. Olsen has it poked away from him and on out to center. Horton's pass is broken up by Melanson again. Melanson jumping on it. Spin move by Melanson to get by Horton. Stick handling further for Rodriguez. Rodriguez turning and firing it off the backboards behind the Harvard goal. To the far point, it goes to Moore. Moore down low. Babella working in front. Backhand shot deflects high in the air to the far corner. No one knows where it is. Finally, it comes down to Moore. Over there is Moore, stick handling it out of traffic, plays it around to the near corner. Rodriguez, the first one to it for RPI. He'll cycle, spinning it out in front. Shot coming, Moore off the post! Into the far side of the Harvard zone. Babella scoops it right back out in front. Harvard reeling now. Liljegren in the corner. He gets dumped from behind by Olsen. To the point, Hampton has it. Far point now, wrist shot coming, glove save, Madsen, an easy stop there, and he'll get a whistle. 13:19 to go in the second period, still no score.
Yeah, Drew Melanson, RPI, has shows they can beat Harvard with their speed. Drew Melanson, like a speed demon, coming in all alone. He just puts the puck wide as he tried to make a move, and then off the post, the second post that was hit this evening for RPI. So RPI getting it behind the goaltender, just not beating the post.
Puck to the line. Bradley had to go through his legs. And now Harvard breaks. Two on one. Esposito and Donato poked away by Prapovesis to the corner. Donato out of the corner. Turning and shooting high. It comes down off the glass to the near point for Bergen. Bergen down low for Esposito. Now Floodstrand. He gets bumped there by Schrader. Floodstrand trying to dig it out. He plays it back to the point for Bergen. Faking a shot. Pulls it back. Takes a shot. Deflected in a pad. Saved by Kasdorf. Carried out by the Engineers, potential 3-on-2, Wood ahead for Bourbonnais, too far for him. He'll pick it up behind the goal in the far corner, leaves it near side for Wood. Wood to the near circle, Prapovesis. Prapovesis back up top for Wood. Wood trying to feed it far side, stolen away by Donato. Donato in a race with Wilson, trying to work his way in, broken up, far side, no shot came. Floodstrand holding, waiting in the far corner, fed in front, deflected wide of goal by Esposito. Now Prapovesis in the near corner, behind for Wilson, and the Engineers will slow down the heart rate of this one just a bit. Prapovesis, near side wall for Nanny, tipped into the zone, controlled by Sherman. He'll go cross ice for Jaw. Ahead into the RPI zone they come, shot wristed, deflected over the top by Ellis. Kasdorf takes a look around, the puck's out of play.
Yeah, and again, this one being very entertaining, second period as well, as both teams having quality opportunities, RPI with the better of the opportunities, but both goaltenders really, really smart and showing maturity and slowing the pace of the game down when needed. So that is not a stat that you see on the score sheet, but very important nonetheless by both Kasdorf and Madsen. 12:03 left to play in the second, no score.
Face-off one back shot comes to flex to the far corner by the Crimson. Moore trying to clear it out far side. He's tied up there by a pair of Crimson, including Tringali. And now walking in, backhand shot saved by Kasdorf. Rebound covered in traffic. And it's underneath the glove of the senior netminder. And now Buffalo Sabres draft possession.
So we'd like to remind you, you are listening to 91.5 FM WRPI Troy. Ed DeGaren along with Perry Lascaris here from the Fieldhouse, bringing you Harvard against RPI Hockey in a very entertaining game thus far. 11:47 left to play in the second, no score.
Draw here, played back around to the far side half wall. Now in deep behind the RPI net, took a little bit of a funny hop off the opening where the Zamboni comes out. Played up the wall, now an outlet pass, and what a pass it is. Engineers are onside, Melanson couldn't quite corral it. It was a home run ball. Melanson tried to stay onside. Now we have a penalty coming up here. It's going to go on Jaw, I believe, and now Tringali is going into it with Wilson, and these players are going to need to be separated. The man who was knocked down, I believe, was Melanson, and he is skating back to the bench right now. Looks to be all right. They will, of course, take a look there, but the Engineers will be going on the power play. Well, they could have gotten Melanson for a slash, but they're definitely getting Jaw from a hit from behind.
Yeah, Jaw is definitely going. We'll see if they put in Wilson for what he did after the whistle. And I don't know if they're going to, but he was definitely going at it down there with a Harvard defenseman. So it only looks like that Jaw is going into the box. And nope, they do put in a RPI player. As going into the box, so this one's going to be.
It was Melanson for slashing.
That's
what I saw.
This is going to be 4-4 as well. So that's what you thought initially, that
yep.
Drew Melanson was going to go. So according to Perry, the right calls were made.
Was a slash on Melanson. And a hit from behind. We'll have 4-4 hockey here for 11:24. Or, excuse me, not for 11:24. That would be a long time. There's 11:24 left in the second. We'll have 4-4 for just 2 minutes. That seems more reasonable. Prabavestis off the wall to himself. Is still on it in the far corner. Still Prabavestis, now it's poked away. Scooped in the air, out to center ice. Knocked down by Babella. He can't find it. Chance to break 2-on-1. Criscolo with Vizi. Centering pass broken up by Bradley. He laid that stick along the ice to break it up. And denying the most potent duo currently in the lineup for the Crimson. Scooped on out to center by Liljegren. Wide of goal will be icing on RPI.
Yeah, 10:56 left to play in the second. No score. Excellent job by Chris Bradley. And he really waited to the last possible second to put his stick down. He read what Vizi was going to do. Didn't do it too early. He did it at just the right time to break that up. And very good patience there by Chris Bradley back on the blue line to break up that 2-on-1.
Draw here coming to the left of Kasdorf. Continue to play 4-on-4. Decent-sized crowd here at the Houston Fieldhouse. As it's won back to the far point for Newell. Near point, Sherman. Wrist shot blocked by Liljegren. He now throws a shoulder into his man. That was Moy. Free behind the goal. Prabavestis will wait it out. Now he skates from behind the goal. Prabavestis, a sophomore in Dallas Stars draft choice out of Oakville, Ontario. Into the zone now. Babella trying to find his shooting lane. It was blocked away. All the way to the point for Bradley. Bradley lines up a slapper. That one's blocked by Moy. He'll control there. Up the far boards and in deep. Behind the goal, it's picked up by Sherman. Sherman from Malone out to center. 2-on-2. Harvard will move it to center ice. Weaving into the zone come the Crimson. Malone pulls it back. Fakes a shot. Poked free by Wilson. Back to Malone. Stolen away by the Engineers. Bourbonnais wants to skate now. 2-on-2 with Nanny. Skating near side. Hands it off for Nanny. Nanny will play it below the goal line for Bourbonnais. Bourbonnais in the corner. Waiting. Still Bourbonnais. All the way to the point. He carries it out and throws it across far side. Down low. Off the back wall for Nanny. He gets bumped by Bergen, stolen away by Newell, and Criscolo out to center. Criscolo makes a move, stolen away by the help defender, Nanny, and now Bergen fires it right back into RPI territory. The Crimson are not offside. Criscolo in well-timed there by Harvard. Now out to center. Bergen goes D-to-D there with Anderson. Shot through neutral ice near side, picked up by Bergen. And we're about to be back to 5-on-5 hockey in just a moment. Here's Vizi into the RPI zone. Tried to make a move, lost it. Engineers look to break. It's off of Moore into Harvard territory. Moore's going to pick it up in the far corner. Try to pull it out of there. Bergen stole it away. 9:12 to go in this second period. No score here still at the Houston Fieldhouse. Miller to the point. Hands it off there. Shot comes wide of goal into the near corner. Hampton. In the corner, we're going to get a puck played with a high stick, I believe. That's what our linesman on the near side, David Brown, was gesturing or motioning for, and that'll draw a whistle.
8:59 left to play in the second. No score, RPI and Harvard. Both teams back at five aside. And RPI doing a really good job this period neutralizing that VZ Cascola line. Tom and I talked about it during the first intermission, and so far RPI has been doing a good job, especially Chris Bradley back on the blue line.
No score here. You're listening to live coverage of RPI Hockey, 91.5 FM, WRPI Troy. Pair of the scarce Edgar Garion from the Houston Fieldhouse. It's Harvard and RPI. Second game of the weekend for the Engineers after falling to Dartmouth. And now breaking into the offensive zone are the Crimson. Donato in the near corner. Help behind by Miller. First one to it. It's going to be Floodstrand for Harvard. To the point. Wrist shot Newell. Blocked out in front. Melanson wants to skate with it. Fed across neatly for Wood. Wood on further for Miller. And that one's broken up. And Harvard's back out the other way. Floodstrand now on the backhand looking for a shot. Put it wide. Caroms around to the far side half wall. Chipped off the boards. Miller there with Wood. Wood on now into the offensive zone. Avoids a hit there from Floodstrand. It's picked up by Olsen. Left in the far corner. Behind the net now Newell. Stops behind the cage. The Crimson look to complete a change and set up the breakout. They're ready now. Newell. Off the glass, out to center. I'm not sure that was the plan, as it swatted right back in for Hampton. Newell again. Behind his own cage. Nearly stolen away. Picked up by Bubella now in the far corner. They do give it away to the point. Near point, Hampton. Lines up a slapper, hits a skate, and trickles to the far side. Back to the far point once more. Moore down low. Liljegren at the side of the cage. It skips away from him to the near side boards. He'll cycle now. Haggerty. Rodriguez, I beg your pardon, down low for Bubella. That's the second time this weekend, and it's going to be kept in. Only dreaming there as it's moved out to center ice. Donato spins around at the point. He'll feed it cross ice, looking for Moy. Moy picks it up in the far corner, watched by Moore. Moore is tied up there. He'll play it on further below the goal line. Zerter Gossage, he's tied up. Moy comes to pick it away. One-handed to the point. Sherman does a nice job handling that one with the skates, finds Vesey. Center blue line draw. A drive was blocked there by Moore. Jaw again, fakes the shot. He'll carry it to the far side circle. Hands it off for Moy. He'll cycle down low for Vesey. Jimmy Vesey behind the goal on his backhand. Spins back behind the cage. Watched by Bubella. Turning with it now. A shot by Moy off the side of the cage. Kalsdorf doesn't see it. Loose to the side still. And we're going to get a whistle here. It's pinned against the post. And now pushing the net down was Chris Colo. And we'll have a stoppage in play. 6:38 to go in the second period.
Yeah, Chris Colo was, he pushed the net back, but he was pushed by an RPI defender as well. So 6:38 left to play in the second. No score, RPI in Harvard. Alex Rodriguez doing a great job there on the ice.
Not the former engineer. I'm not sure he's doing well in Peoria. There's a bouncing puck picked up by Bourbonnais. He'll scoop it high in the air and into the near corner, race for it. Wave off the icing. Nanny did a good job there. Now Schrader throws a shoulder into Jaw, who's not having a good day. Bourbonnais walking in front, driving the cage. He spins all the way to the near circle. Fed far side, Wilson, a shot, and a glove save by Madsen. He holds on.
That was a great save by Madsen. It looked routine, but there was a bunch of traffic in front of him, and he just flashed the leather and prevented the go-ahead goal. RPI really turning on the pressure in this game.
Shot, face-off coming here. It'll be to the right of Madsen, one back to the point. Bradley for Prapavesas makes a spin move to the near side circle. Prapavesas still on it, holding. Turns back towards the near side hash marks now. Fed in front, glove down by Anderson. Should be a hand pass. And that's a touchdown engineer. Oh, they wave it off. And now we get a whistle. That's definitely a hand pass. Oh boy. It's not so much that they got the call right or wrong. The fans just don't like how this game has been officiated overall.
Well, you're right. It should have been a hand pass before, but they waited till an engineer touched the puck on the blue line to blow the whistle, ruining an engineer opportunity. And the call was right. It just happened 10 seconds after the fact.
Carasone's taking responsibility for it, which is fine.
Yes.
Just, I think one linesman waved it off. One called it. referee called it. It's just a matter of communication there. Face off in the Harvard zone. One back to the point again. Bradley, wrist shot, blocked. Sits there at the point. Bradley trying to avoid his teammate Wood. Finds Jesper Orvall. He'll slide it below the goal line. Near side corner. Melanson's going to track it down. Now Wood out of the corner. Into the middle of the ice. Prabavez is a wrister. And takes a deflection. And comes free to the near side. Chipped on out to center. Prabavez is controlling there. Fires it down the middle. Miller knocks him down. Wood picks it up. Wood into the zone. A shot off a skate. Loose in front. And trying to stick it home there. Comes free to Bradley. Wrist shot off a body. And it comes free to the near side wall again. Far point now. Holding Prapavesis. Fanned on the pass. Puck moved out to center by Horton. Here's Lloyd into the RPI zone. Stops far side. Center ice Anderson. Poked it to the near corner. Horton trying to get away from the stick of Orvall. Played behind the goal. Prapavesis. And that one's to the side of the cage. Kasdorf has it covered. 5:02 left. In the second period, still no score.
Yeah, RPI really getting the bulk of the chances here in this period. Really outplaying Harvard, out hustling, out manning them, and doing a good job. They've done everything so far but put the puck in the back of the net. 5:02 left to play in the second, no score. Reminder, second intermission, we have an interview with Dr. Lee McElroy, the athletic director here at RPI.
Draw coming here, left side of the RPI, far side of the RPI zone, left to Kasdorf. Kasdorf, as Olsen keeps it in along the boards, taking a hit there from Rodriguez. Kicked at by Hampton. Lost it in the near circle on the poke check. Bobella can't clear. Olsen on goal, blocked by Moore. And he'll skate it near side, high off the glass and out to center. Skips by Olsen. Olsen fires it off the far boards. In the air, knocked down by Moore. Moore skates back to his own end, wrap it around to the near side. Chopped at by Rodriguez. Kept in there by Olsen at the point. Scooped in the air again over the top of the RPI net. Moore has his man Floodstrand pinned against the boards. Now Liljegren out to center all by himself, trying to help it up the wall. Tied up there, 4:20 left here. In the second, poke free, Esposito. His teammate touches up, he's all by himself in the offensive zone. It caroms off the sideboards, his shot, and then Esposito runs into Moore. Schrader has his man pinned in the corner, that's Donato. They continue to work in front of the Zamboni door, far side of the RPI zone. Moore takes a bump from Esposito. Kicked free, Esposito at the net. Wraparound try, blocked away. Still behind the cage, chipped towards the point, kept in there, Olsen. Intentionally firing wide to the far side of the RPI zone. Poked towards the point, and the puck was in the air. It'll leave the zone. Back to pick it up is Newell. It was a great job to get away from Liljegren, who was putting some forecheck pressure on. Now Wilson throws a hit. Puck out to center. Moy spins it back into RPI territory. Skips it on goal. Kasdorf will just let it play for Reno. 3:26 left in the second. Still scoreless here. Puck played to the near wall. Skips by Moy. Controlled by Bourbonnais. Bourbonnais stick handling the Harvard territory. Still Bourbonnais goes down and throws it behind the goal. Poked up in the air. Around to the near corner. Skated out to center by Sherman. On further. Chris Colo takes a hit there. As it's picked up by the engineers. Nanny tips it out to center ice. Bourbonnais with some room. And it will be a two-on-two when they gather. Drop pass Melanson. He'll skate in. Far side corner. Drops it back to the point. Hit a skate. Picked up Vizi. He'll go the other way. Vizi one-on-two into the RPI zone. His teammates changing behind him. He'll just spin around and rag the puck for a bit in his own zone. Fed through center. RPI maybe caught chasing the puck a little bit here. The shot comes wide of the goal. Caroms all the way out to center. Now Bergen, backtracking to his own zone. Feeds it near side for Malone. Sean Malone to center, dumping it in. It'll be behind the RPI goal now. Now a centering pass right out in front for Malone. A lot of zip on the pass and he doesn't connect. Chipped up the wall all the way down. This should be icing on RPI. 2:10 to go in the second period while we have this stoppage. And I give a shout out to the RPI and Harvard alums watching and listening to tonight's game at the Stout Public House in beautiful San Diego, California. Thanks for tuning in, guys and gals out there in California. I can't blame you. It's not all that nice outside here at the Houston Fieldhouse, but it's not bad inside. I will tell you that. RPI and Harvard playing to, right now, a scoreless tie as the puck is flipped into the near corner. Wraps around to the point. Bergen will keep it in. Poke free, and now Malone behind the cage. Pick it up by Prapovesis. Off the glass, bouncing puck, and won't leave the zone. Horton picks it up there, fed to the far circle. Malone walking in, still Malone, high and wide. He ripped it, and he knows it. Should have done better with that. As he was all by himself, he takes an angry skate back to the bench. 1:39 to go in the second period. Shots are 31-12, Harvard. But the Engineers have hit the post twice, so really, this game could be headed in any direction.
We'll make it work.
Draw here to the left of Kasdorf. Liljegren on the draw against Donato. One back to the point. Newell has it there. Takes a slap shot. That one's blocked away to the corner. Parker Reno has it now. Looking to play it behind his own goal. Up the boards, and now Liljegren. Tried to make a move, lost the puck. And the Crimson will take over in the neutral zone. Olsen fires in wide of goal. Kasdorf helps it to the side of the cage. It's controlled by Wilson. Wilson in the corner. He's tied up there. Donato trying to work it free. Thrown in front for Esposito. Can't quite control the pass. Slap shot coming. That might have grazed the outside of the post. Olsen fires it wide of the goal. Caroms around to the far side half wall. Cycling are the Crimson down low. Wilson helps it to the near side. RPI just trying to survive this final couple minutes here. Donato has it poked away. Chipped out the center by Rodriguez. Well weighted, Rodriguez, to avoid the icing. 1 minute to go, and the fans on their feet here. Looking for free stuff are the fans. They get excited, of course. Shot around to the near wall for Nanny. Touch pass, broken up. Engineers have to start over again. As Babella plays it off the wall, cross ice, gave it away. Vizi walking in to the slot. Vizi turning and shooting, and it deflects wide. He may have been looking to find Chris Colo there. Unable to do so. Trying to work it up the near wall. Stolen away, Chris Colo to the slot. Turning, shooting. Blocked away by Kasdorf. Vizi now from a tight angle. Tried to throw it off of Kasdorf. This will leave the zone. Vizi trying to do it there. Was a low percentage play. It's right back in with 1 second to go in the period. Big collision to end the first period, or excuse me, the second period here. No score, RPI and number 8 Harvard after 40 minutes at the Houston Fieldhouse. And Ed, more excitement here in the second. The Engineers in the post for the second time, but we still have no score.
Yeah, I think the Engineers had the majority of the better play. I think they did a great job neutralizing BZ and Piscolo, especially in the 2-on-1 by Chris Bradley. And I just mentioned to Dr. McElroy on the way up here is both goaltenders, are really, really good shutdown quality goaltenders, and they're showing it here today, and it's what's really been a goaltending clinic in this hockey game. So no score here, RPI and Harvard, and that's the way, it ended the way in the first period as well. So
we'll take a break here, be back. We have RPI Athletic Director Dr. Lee McElroy that Ed will have a conversation with during our second intermission. A reminder, your score after two periods is RPI nothing and Harvard nothing. You're listening to live coverage of RPI hockey on 91.5 FM, WRPI Troy.
run back to study after they work. That's what Division III is all about, and that's what I like about it.
So does that change the mindset of a coach when he recruits? Does he recruit a different caliber of student-athlete compared to a Division I school?
Oh, absolutely, because, again, the challenge is you have to balance the academics and the athletics. But the D3 athletes I've found, and I've been here 8 months now, they're just as committed, if not more so, to athletics than the Division I athletes.
And what would we see? You know, Penn State obviously got into college hockey a few years ago. Arizona State, who's going to be in the field house here next weekend.
Right.
What's going to be the impact if more of those bigger BCS schools, if you will, start getting involved with college hockey?
Well, one is that it's providing more opportunities. That's good. What is not good, as you indicated, Penn State and Arizona State, the Power Five conferences have significantly more resources. So, for example, they can provide stipends. And the ECAC schools do not provide that at this point. And even Hockey East at this point do not provide stipends. So the Big Ten provides stipends because they're a Power Five conference and they have all the money. So while I like to see the growth of hockey and the more opportunities, I'm very concerned about the resources at the Power Five level.
And do you think we've seen a little bit of realignment? Of course, Notre Dame going to Hockey East and no more CCHA and the rise of the Big Ten and the NCHC. Do you think it's going to have more of a trickle-down effect? Do you think we're going to see more realignment, or are we going to, schools are going to resist that?
I don't think we're going to see more realignment. I think what you're going to see are philosophical differences. And one we've talked about, one is the stipend, which is anywhere from $5,000 to $8,000 a year per player. That's a lot of money for a college kid. And then the other thing is whether or not kids are going to seriously pursue the NHL. Let's face it, most of them, that's their dream. So when you balance the stipend, when you balance the education, and you balance the NHL prospects, I think philosophically, that's why I think the ECAC is doing it the right way.
And we mentioned the Big Ten, and one of the proposals they're proposing now is to lower the age of freshmen from 21 to 20 that can, that can enter. And fans seem to think it's because they recruit more of the younger kids at 14, 15, and to hold back some of the smaller schools. From an athletic director point of view, is that the case, or is that not going to be the case?
Well, first of all, let me go on record as saying I've talked to Coach Appert about this, and we are opposed to the Big Ten bylaw and proposal, and we're opposed to it for two reasons. One, at the RPIs and most of the ECAC schools, kids have an opportunity to grow and develop and to prosper, and so we get a little older kid. What the bigger people want to do in a Power Five conference, they want to get them younger because they have the resources to develop them that we don't have. So we're opposed to the Big Ten proposal. I'll be voting against it at the NCAA convention, and I don't think it can pass.
And you said you were new to Division I hockey.
Right.
Back to you for a second. You said you were new. What are some of the things you're learning and enjoying about?
Well, the first thing that I learned from hockey, I went to my first national convention last March, is it's inclusive. When I would go to football and basketball conventions, people would rarely talk. All the Division II people would be in the room. The Division I people would be in the room. Division III people would be in the room. In hockey, everybody's in the room. Division I, Division II, Division III, and the club people are in the room, and they all are sitting there sharing ideas to make the sport grow. And that's unique to hockey, and that's what I love about it.
And you, Albany, obviously getting a Division I lacrosse team. You were new to lacrosse as well. Mm-hmm. I'm going to sort of put you on the spot. What do you like better, lacrosse or hockey?
Right now I like hockey better, and the reason, it's very similar. First of all, there are 60-plus schools in Division I in hockey and lacrosse. The thing about hockey, though, you've got kids from Sweden, we've got kids from Canada, we've got kids from the States. There's more diversity in hockey than there is in lacrosse, and that's why I like it better.
All right. Obviously, from a hockey fan perspective, that's good to hear that you know, you're going to back the hockey program.
Yeah.
So I think we can get back to the game and enjoy it. And thank you.
Well, thank you for having me, and I can't wait to watch this this third one.
Yeah, it's going to be exciting if the first two periods were any indication. So thank you very much
for
coming on, and we certainly appreciate that. And
thank you.
And so that There you go, straight from the AD's mouth. We talked a lot about proposal and the implications of college hockey and stuff like that. So thank you very much to Dr. Lee McElroy for joining me here today. So we'll take a short break. We'll be back here for the third period. The score here after two periods of play is RPI 0, Harvard 0. You're listening to live coverage of Indian Hockey on 91.5 FM, WRPI. to Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute in Troy, New York, and the Houston Fieldhouse for the third period of action for tonight's game between the RPI Engineers and the Harvard Crimson. The score here after two periods of play is the same as it was when it's, the first puck was dropped. RPI and Harvard both have no score. Great game so far by Jason Kasdorf and Merrick Madison in that for the Engineers and the Crimson, respectively. So before we get started with the third period of play, we'd like to thank the Rensselaer Union, which provides the funding for WRPI and all club-related activity of the Institute, including WRPI's coverage of RPI men's and women's hockey, football, and baseball. We'd also like to thank you for listening out on the World Wide Web. Point your browser to www.wrpi.org, and you can hear our broadcast 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. So long as we are broadcasting, we will have the broadcast on the internet feed. Once again, it is www.wrpi.org. I'd also like to thank Dr. Lee McElroy for joining me for the second period of intermission. A lot of great quality stuff and insights into his career and stuff going around college hockey.
Ready for the third period, RPI and Harvard. Shots were 33-12 after two. There were 13-5 Crimson in the second period. Harvard 0 for 1 in the power play. RPI also, did I say 0 for 1? I meant 0 for 1. Harvard 0 for 1, RPI 0 for 1. We are 5-on-5 hockey to start the third. Engineers skating from right to left. And it's the Crimson who break out to center ice. Long stretch pass for Vesey. Played by Kasdorf in the end. It came all the way to him. Loose in the far circle. Driving the net. Vesey poked away. Near side. Babella plays it back behind the goal for Reno. Parker Reno, far boards. Rodriguez to center for Milos Babella. He'll skate into the zone near side. Poked off his stick by the back check of Moy. Chris Colo now takes a bump. Vesey into the attacking zone. Vesey makes a move on Bradley, right to the post, and he hit it. He hit it off the near post, and now back come the Engineers. Wood on the move. Poked off his stick, picked up by Sherman. Chips it out to center. Fans want a too many men call. Not going to get it. Engineers break in. And we're going to get a penalty here. It's going to be a slash. Miller was tripped up on his way to the net. And just 56 seconds into the third, RPI going the power play for the second time.
19:04 left to play in the third. RPI and Harvard no score again. It's Jaw going into the penalty box. He's been having a rough night back on the Harvard blue line. So RPI will get another chance on the power play, close to cracking it and finding the net, but nothing doing so far.
Puck to the near corner. Back out to the far point now, Wilson. Chopped at. Played. Anderson tripped up, and there goes the RPI power play.
18:49 left to play in the third. Yep. No score, only a minute and 46 seconds remaining, so only 14 seconds into the RPI power play. Milos Bubella goes to the penalty box, so 4-on-4 for the next minute and 46 seconds, and Harvard will have a brief 14-second power play. 18:49 left to play in the third, no score here at the Fieldhouse.
Draw one back, Bergen. Holding, waiting, takes a shot, deflected over the top of the RPI net, poked at by Esposito, as Bradley chops at his stick. He gets roughed up and knocked down by Bradley, and the puck comes free behind the RPI goal for Mike Prapavesas. Prapavesas near side, too far for Nanny. No icing here as Nanny picks it up behind the Harvard goal. Trying to steer it out of there, poked free by Anderson. He goes down again, this time on his own accord. He's now tied up in the far corner of the Harvard zone by Schrader. Esposito off the wall. Trickles in front of the Harvard goal. Thought about playing it. Madsen, he didn't. As the Crimson play it behind their own goal now. Chipped off the boards. Pass Prapavesas. Trying to skate around to Donato. Nearly got there. Now he does. Ryan Donato in the far corner. Poked off his stick. Nanny takes it away. Lou Nanny near side. Too far for Newell. He'll go D-to-D with it for Sherman. Now Vesey picking up speed to the neutral zone. Makes a move around one man. Poke free by Reno. Vesey behind the cage. Poked away again. Now the net comes over the top of Kasdorf. Off its pegs. Water bottle flies. And we're going to get a whistle. That was just good defense there by Lou Nanny taking the body on VZ. What you have to do because he tries to kind of slide by you.
Yeah, 17-38 left to play in the third. No score, RPI and Harvard. And RPI not letting Jimmy VZ hurt them. So just far as the net came crashing down right over the top of Jason Kasdorf, who really did a good job of protecting himself as the net didn't even touch him. It just came and just rolled right over the top of him. 17-38 left to play in the third. No score. And 34 seconds remaining in Harvard penalty and 49 remaining in Bubelage.
Curious to see that collision there from the RPI TV net cam. That's been installed in both nets here. 17:35 left in the third. No score, RPI and Harvard. Another 27 seconds left to 4-on-4 time. Before the Crimson will have a very brief power play. Bourbonnais stick handling through the neutral zone. Melanson didn't realize the puck never went into the zone, so he was all by himself in the offensive end. Engineers had to dump in. Big collision along the near wall as Wood hits Chris Colo. Wilson trying to feed it on for Jake Wood. Jumped right on it, Melanson carrying to the slot, now near circle. Lots of room for Wilson. A drive and a save is made on the glove by Madsen.
Well, I think Madsen's glove was down on the stick, on the ice rather, and at the same time, Jake Wood's stick was down on the ice, and I think the puck just got into Madsen's glove before it hit Wood's stick. Otherwise, Jake Wood probably would have deflected that one up over into the net, but nothing doing. 17:03 left to play in the third, no score.
Fed to the far corner, Seb Lloyd over to pick it up for Harvard. Moved out to center, crossing center and dumping it in. Penalty about to expire on Babella as the Engineers carry out to center ice, chipped high off the glass. They had to watch out there as Babella came out of the box. Now we get a puck play with a high stick. That'll draw a whistle, 16:45 on the clock in the third.
Yeah, very clear high stick against Clay Anderson, and Anderson's actually kind of lucky that Bubelo didn't come out of the box quite yet. Otherwise, he probably would have seen a two-minute penalty instead of just an infraction. 16:45 left to play in the third. No score, RPI and Harvard.
Draw here, near side of the Harvard zone. Back towards Moore, who fires it off the backboard. Schrader. Spins back to the near side, trying to find Bourbonnais through his legs. Now a shot by Moore off the post again! And Madsen didn't have it covered. He didn't see the shot. He knew he needed to get there. But in the end, it could have snuck by him just the same. Now Hampton a shot. Engineers have hit three posts tonight. But we're still scoreless. Bourbonnais off the wall, hands it off for Moore. Goal line extended, near side, throws it right out in front. Caroms to the far point. Hampton a drive, deflected on goal and steered away by Madsen. Horton will clear to center. Knocked down there by Moore. He takes a hit, picked up, and Nanny will skate it in. Cross ice feed for no one in particular. Picked up by Bergen, fires it out to center. Tapped in deep by Lloyd. Prapavesis, near side for Bradley. Up to the RPI blue line and cross ice feed for Melanson. On for Hampton, he fires it way wide of goal, make it Schrader rather, backhanded in front, turning Schrader, shooting, another stop by Miller, rebound turned away by Madsen, and the puck is cleared, net comes off, and Harvard will not be allowed to change. They'll say that the Crimson moves the net from its moorings. Engineers knocking on the door here at...
Again, RPI very, very close to putting it, they're actually getting it behind Madsen, but like I said, they can't beat the post. Three posts you mentioned by Moore, and I think the one drive there by Bradley again hit the post as it caromed out wide. So four posts hit by RPI. 15:36 left to play in the third, no score.
Maybe John Bougegrass was right. Maybe we need bigger nets. Backhand shot blocked away. And the Engineers clear out to center. And all, excuse me, the Crimson do all the way down. This should be icing again. So this group will have to stay out there for Harvard.
Yeah, RPI really, really taking it to them. They come out as fast as as fast as Harvard came out in the first period against RPI. RPI is coming out fast again in this period. So RPI is equal, if not better, so far, beating Harvard to the loose pucks.
Face-off, one back behind the Harvard goal. It's Newell. Out to center. Skips by Bradley and all the way down. Will this be icing? Yes, it will. We'll do it again. Same group, right back to their own zone.
So we saw in the first period, RPI took about five icings right in a row. Now Harvard has an icing problem. So 15-12 left to play in the third. No score.
An icing problem here. Shots are now 33-16, 4-0 RPI here in the third. in the shot department. They've also hit a post. That does not count. Melanson to the slot on the backhand, throws it on goal, and it's held onto by Madsen with Miller lurking.
Now Harvard will finally take that change that they wanted to. Madsen holding on to the puck to get his team off the ice and to get fresh legs. 15:07 left to play. Shots 33-17 in favor of the Crimson right now, but RPI really with the more quality chances so far.
Shot by Rodriguez. The net came off its moorings, but then came right back down on them. And Madsen kicked it off. Inadvertently, of course, now moved in by Rodriguez in the circle. Trying to move to the far side of the ice. Lost the puck. Taken away by Moy. He'll try the near side for Criscolo. Wilson looks to pinch. Awkward hit with Criscolo. But Babella on the carry to the circle. Shot coming high off the glass. Caroms to the far side point. Kept in Reno. Off the wall, Liljegren. Near point, Wilson. Fed in front, looking for a deflection. No one sticks her on the ice. Now a low shot. Net kicked off. The save was made again by Madsen. And this is an old rink, the Houston Fieldhouse. And on occasion, these pegs become a little bit easy to come off the ice. And that's what we're seeing here. Madsen, of course, not trying to kick the net off. He's just trying to get his foot to the post. And doing so has kicked it off a couple times.
Yeah, 14:32 left to play in the third. And you mentioned it, Perry, but... You know, give a lot of credit to RPI, really taking it to Harvard right now. It looks like RPI is the eighth-ranked team in the country so far in this third period.
Shots now 6-0 Engineers in the third. Bouncing puck out to center. Reno trying to kick at it. Here comes Vizi. A shot off the post and out. Criscolo a drive off the pad of Kasdorf and out of play. I believe it's 3-2 RPI if we're playing posts. But if you put it, have to put it in the net, it's still 0-0.
Unbelievable. I mean, I'm speechless. I don't know what to say. Both goalies playing well, but also both goalies coming up lucky with both posts. If everything was put in the net, be 3-2 right now, but no score. 14:22 left to play in the third.
I was going to say, can't be speechless right now, but it's kind of your job. Anderson off the faceoff win, feeds it down low, thrown through the top of the crease. And the Engineers pick it up on the other side. Nanny high off the glass into Harvard territory. No, knocked down at center ice. Nice play by Bergen. Ahead for Floodstrand. His shot deflects off a stick up into the netting. We'll have another stoppage in play.
Yeah, 14:05 left to play in the third. And both teams really, really putting on a great, entertaining hockey game. I mean, even if you're watching at home and listening on the radio, and if your heart is racing, believe me, it's that time about two here in the field house.
Puck to the far side corner. They tie up in the far corner of the RPI zone. Bradley knocks down Esposito. Donato off the wall, stolen away again by Bradley. He'll throw it off the glass, glove down Bergen, backtracking out of the zone. Puck leaves it with him. Nanny up the wall. He gets knocked down by Esposito. Bourbonnais comes to help out. And it's now loose at center. Donato trying to kick it ahead to himself. Crimson are a bit discombobulated there. One of them is offside. Now they have to back up. That allows the Engineers to take over in their own end. Here's Nanny down the middle. Nanny lets it run far side for Schrader. Firing a shot towards goal. It was blocked by Bergen. High in the air. Comes bouncing behind the goal. Very, very odd game we've had here so far. As Bergen plays it up the far side boards all the way down. No icing here as Hampton tied up Lloyd on its way through. Moore steps around a check, but lost the puck to Horton. And now Horton gets it back. Back down low for Malone. Malone trying to walk it out in front. Skips by Kasdorf, who's trying to cover, and is put behind the net by Hampton. Now a tie-up in the corner, trying to find the puck once more. It's Lloyd centering all the way through and out to center past Olsen. He'll stop at center and fire it right back in. Karam is around to the near side half wall. Reno back for Moore. Moore will fire it around the far side, rolling out to center. Olsen will claim it in his own zone far side. 12 and a half to go in the third. No score here. Good outlet pass to Malone. He's triple teamed and lost the puck. It's kicked to the corner for Reno. Back behind for Wilson. RPI looks to break out near side. Oh, pass too far out in front of Miller, although he gets it back off the deflection. Miller, a shot right on and a save to the near corner. He's tied up there by Newell. And Harvard breaks to the far side of the own zone, out to center. It's gloved down there, fanned on a couple times by Reno, shot in by Wood. Madsen will just stop it behind his own goal. Jaw, poke checked away by Wood. Centering pass swept away by Ellis. And now far side, Tringali to center. That's knocked out of the air nicely by Reno. And right back the other way comes Milos Babela, though it's poked away from him by Ellis. Tringali backhands it into RPI territory, where it's played by Reno. To the far side for Wood. Wood off the skate of Prapovesis, shot back into RPI territory. Ellis couldn't touch it because he was offside. The engineers will shoot it near side for Liljegren. He's pinned against the boards by Zerder Gossage. On out to center it goes, tracking it down with Braden Jaw in his own zone. Fed far side, tapped in deep by Ellis. Harvard wants a change. Kasdorf will stop it there. The senior netminder for RPI, up to 33 stops in this one. His shots are 33-20 in favor of the visiting Crimson. Puck bottled up at the RPI line. Who wants it? Victor Liljegren. He'll pick it away and fire it in. To the corner it goes. Schrader, the first one to it behind the cage. He'll help it to the near side for Rodriguez. Alex Rodriguez cycling for Schrader. Centering it all in front. Took a deflection off of Moy. And now he looks to find Vizi, but Vizi not on the same page. This will be icing on Harvard with 10:48 to play in the third in a scoreless game.
Yeah, RPI and Harvard, both teams finding the offense really pouring on. And this is a great wide open game. A very, very entertaining hockey game. The style that Seth Haber wants to play for the last 10 years. He's finally able to do that. 10:48 left to play in the third. No score, RPI Harvard.
Draw one, back to the far point. Shot goes wide from Prapovesis. Wrap around Triborbonet. That one's turned away. And now back comes Vizi. 3-on-2 for Harvard to center ice. Near side, Vizi into the zone. Looks to pass it in front for Gerskolo. Poked away by Prapovesis. And the engineers will carry it back the other way. Melanson fed through center for Bourbonnais. He can't find it. And it goes trickling back into the far side of the Harvard zone. Anderson off the glass. Skips by Bradley. All the way in on goal. Kasdorf will leave it at the side of the net for Reno. Pressure comes from Gerskolo. Stolen away by Moy. Played for Vizi. A shot off the side of the goal. Bradley will try the near side. Skips on out to center. Controlled there by Harvard. It's Olsen. Off the glass. Kicked at by Liljegren. He'll carry into the offensive zone. Pulls it back. Takes a wrister. Save made. Wraparound try. Comes free to the point. Kept in by Reno. Down low it goes for Bourbonnais. Skip behind the goal to the near side corner. Babela fires a shot from a tight angle off the back of the net. Bourbonnais to the point for Reno. Near point, Wilson pulls it back. He'll fire wide of goal. Karam's off the back of the cage to the far side. Babela, fans on their feet here, or at least getting into it a little bit, as it's played at the side of the cage by Reno. Fed to the middle of the ice, and we get a whistle, and the net is off. 9:31 to play third period. Really anyone's game at this point, Ed, in a scoreless game.
Yeah, I think some of the fans wanted an interference against the Crimson, but there was none to be had, so I think the fans are just complaining for the sake of complaining. 9:31 left to play in the third. No score, RPI and Harvard, and they have to drill the post back to hold the net in place, which always draws the cheer from the RPI faithful here at the Fieldhouse. So both teams really, really, Milos Kubela and Drew Melanson really trying to find the net along with Riley Bourbonnais. And the scoreboard says 0-0, but there's been three actually put behind Madsen, two put behind Kasdorf, but all five of them hit the post. So that's where we stand in this hockey game.
No score, 9.5 to play, third period, faceoff coming in the Harvard zone. Miller up against Esposito on the faceoff. Esposito getting a talking to here from the linesman on the far side. That's David Brown. Played up the boards. Through Hampton, now a chance down low. Shot coming, save Kasdorf. Rebound swept away by Miller in the right spot there, the senior centerman. And now to center comes Wood on the stick handle. Throws it right to the line, picked away by Jaw. Heading back the other way, Esposito. Near side, Donato, and they're offside at the line, says Ryan Knapp.
9:11 left to play in the third. RPI and Harvard tied at zero here from the Fieldhouse. We also have to mention that earlier on in the Fieldhouse, the RPI women took on Brown this afternoon in Troy and came away with a 2-0 victory.
First collegiate shutout for Lavisa Solander. And the first career goal for RPI for McKenna Thomas. A couple of freshmen there contributing to RPI's ECAC League win. Back to action here at the Houston Fieldhouse. It's RPI and Harvard. 9 minutes to go in the third period. We still don't have a goal. Played to the far side now. Nanny hands it off for Schrader. Schrader to the circle. Spins around and plays it. He'll hold on to it. Thought he was going to give it over to Bourbonnais. They continue to duel it out in the corner. Schrader's stick knocked out of his hands. Penalty coming up here. We're going to get a slash. And it's going to go on the Crimson with 8:38 left in this third period. Now, the last time the Engineers had a power play, Milos Babela took one 14 seconds into it. And that really kind of killed the momentum that the Engineers would have gotten from that man advantage.
Yeah, and, you know, now RPI gets another chance and really taking it to Harvard. They're just a matter of time. And the referees, as chippy as it was in the first period, has reeled this game back in.
Shot coming, Madsen saw all the way, and the try from Hampton, Hampton has just the two career goals, looking for number three there.
Sean Malone in the penalty box, 2 seconds have elapsed on the power play.
Clearing effort by the Crimson all the way down, it comes bouncing in wide of the RPI goal. Kasdorf will just leave it there. Kasdorf, 20 saves in the first, 13 in the second. Three so far here in the third. RPI outshooting the Crimson 10-3 in the period. Schrader has it near corner. Stops with it there. Fed up the boards near side for Moore. Far point now. Hampton carries it to the near point. Moore near circle holding. Far point for Wood. Wood backed up all the way to the top of the zone. Now center blue line Moore. Wood down low. Finds Bourbonnais. Centering pass looking for Schrader. Puck pops in the air. Everyone kind of froze for a moment. Now it's popped in the air, out of play, and the faceoff will come outside the zone. That's what Jimmy Veazey says, and Jimmy Veazey is going to get it. I think it did come off of Schrader.
Yeah, that's the right call, as Zach Schrader sort of knocked it out of play. I think Schrader thought it went out of play beforehand, too. That's why he sort of froze for a second.
Bouncing puck at center ice after the neutralized draw. Shot in by Babela. Race for the puck. Braden Jaws is going to try and slam it out. And he does all the way down. Chris Bradley with some pressure from Moy. He'll play it far side. Babela just flung it to the near side of his own zone where there was some space and not any Harvard forecheckers. Melanson skates to center with it. With speed now into the offensive zone. Drew Melanson drops it back. Krapovesis. He'll stick handle along the wall. Moving it down low further for Melanson. At the half boards, near side Melanson with it, carries to the point. One-timer shot deflects wide off the skate of Prapovesis. Now far point, down low, Prapovesis walking in, trying to jam it home, and a save is made by Madsen. Harvard trying to clear near side. First one to it is Babela, keeping it alive in the zone. Melanson tracks it down there in the near corner. 22 seconds to go in the RPI power play. Prapovesis helps it to the corner for Melanson. Melanson down low for Prapovesis. Under 7 to go here in the third. Scoreless game. To the near corner now. Melanson to the circle. Far side feed. Shot coming high over the top. It may have gotten a piece of a Manson's glove on the way through. 5 seconds to go in the power play. Melanson to the slot. Far side. Near point Wilson. Wrist shot coming off the crossbar. That's four. Prapovesis down low. Behind the goal, Melanson trying to feed it out in front. It's broken up by Malone. Five skaters aside. His jaw backhands it all the way down the ice. This will be icing, and a blatant one at that from the senior Braden Jaw.
6:22 left to play in the third. No score. RPI and Harvard. The post count, if you will, still rises now to 6. 4 for RPI, 2 for Harvard. You got to think one of these teams is going to find that and put it actually in between the two posts and underneath the crossbar and into the back of the net. And RPI fans are hoping that it's RPI who does.
Back to the far point. Hampton can't control. He'll feed it near side. Rodriguez shoots it in. They'll stop at the half wall and fire it into the far corner. Liljegren battles there with Anderson. Liljegren comes away with it. He'll cycle. Lots of room down there. Miller driving the net. Loose to the near side circle. Liljegren back to the point for Moore. That deflects to the near corner. Rodriguez now. He gets roughed up there by Anderson. Miller keeps it in along the near boards. As does Rodriguez. Malone takes a look around. He'll try the far side. Hampton pinching in. He absorbs a hit there from Lloyd. Far corner of the RPI zone. It's turned into a heavyweight bout here. 5:35 left to go in this one. Rodriguez can't control. Loose in the circle. Lilz are going to quick shot. Rebound jabbed at by Miller. He tried to knock it out of the air. Tie up along the far boards now. Harvard zone. Hampton. For Rodriguez in the corner. Harvard player lost his stick. It was Sherman. He gets it back. Schrader behold the goal line. He's being hounded by Horton and taken down. Harvard trying to clear. Glove down out of the air by Hampton. Used the full extension to glove that puck down. Now Schrader, a wrist shot, hits a pad of the defenseman and trickles to the far corner. Now Schrader throws the body into the man along the far boards to keep the play alive in the offensive zone. Good pressure here from RPI. Flung back by Nanny. It might have taken a deflection on his way through. I don't think he was intending to fire it that hard. Now Wilson. Ahead for Lou Nanny. Drop pass. Center blue line. Gave it away. Here comes Harvard. 2-on-1. Donato has Esposito. Esposito on the move. Saved by Kasdorf on the left pad. And the Engineers skate back the other way. Schrader at the end of a shift. Plays it far side. Chop back into the RPI zone. Esposito runs into Wilson. He picks it up in the far corner. Played it far side. Intercepted by Bourbonnais. He'll skate to center. Riley Bourbonnais. Into the offensive zone, poked off his stick, picked up by Newell. Newell behind the cage, feeds it near side on the backhand. Helped on out to center by Floodstrand. Engineers have tilted the ice back in their favor here in the third period after it was in their end for much of the first two. Prapavesis down the middle for Brubella. Carrying into the offensive zone. Babella on the one-handed shield, throwing it in front, looking for the deflection from Wood, and it popped out of play. 3:49 to go here in the third. Still no score.
And shots 37-25 right now in favor of Harvard, but still no score on the scoreboard. Jason Kasdorf and Merrick Madsen in net for the Engineers and the Crimson, respectively. Both goaltenders really, really putting on a goaltender clinic. And really, both goaltenders coming in with quality stats, and some of the best goaltenders in the country are on display here tonight, and it's showing.
Puck goes into the far corner. Sherman up the far wall now and poked into the zone. Chris Colo, one-on-one, a shot and a glove save by Kasdorf. He fired that one right through the legs of Wilson, but the senior netminder was able to make the glove save.
Yeah, quick cat-like reflexes for Jason Kasdorf. And flashing the glove and making the save and keeping this one scoreless. That was the best chance that Harvard had this period. And Kasdorf was able to say no thank you. 3:37 left to play in the third, no score.
Draw coming far side of the RPI zone. Played around to the near side corner for Wilson, ahead for Melanson. Off the skate of Babella, stick knocked out of the hand of Wood. He's got a new one right away. That's Dana McGuane for you. It's also his birthday. Happy birthday to the big guy. Showing off his talents there. Had Wood a stick in less than a second there. Turning and shooting Moy all the way through to the far side. Leaves the zone, and we get a whistle here as the net came off. Faceoff coming outside the zone. They'll say it was knocked off by a Crimson skater.
Like to remind you, you are listening to 91.5 FM WRPI Troy. Coverage of Engineers men's hockey against the 8th-ranked Harvard Crimson. No score, RPI and Harvard at the Garen and Perry Lascaris on the call for you from the Houston Fieldhouse in what has been a very, very entertaining game.
91.5 FM, WRPI Troy. As Mike Prapavesis has it in his own zone. Bradley near side for Liljegren. Cross ice feed, Rodriguez shoots it in. Madsen stops it behind his own goal. Now he'll let it run. Miller lost his stick. He still battles to keep it alive with his skates. Liljegren throwing in front. Rebound Rodriguez. He can't find it. Miller's trying to pick up his stick, and the puck came right back to him. Now the goaltender, Madsen, without a stick. Prapavesis lines one up, and it's blocked. Floodstrand got all of that one, and now Donato back the other way. 2-on-2, a shot right on, and Kasdorf makes the save.
Again, 2:35 left to play in the third. No score, RPI and Harvard, and fans on the edge of their seat in this one. as nobody has seemed to want to get up and leave. They're afraid they're going to miss something that happens. And, yeah, can you blame them watching this game? Very entertaining back-and-forth action. And both goalies doing a great job.
Kasdorf up to 40 saves in the game. He had a disputed now, I believe, 47 for a career high up against Alaska of Anchorage, which Coach Seth Appert says there weren't that many shots, but we have to go by what happened there. 47 is the season high and career high. Season high for any RPI goaltender, career high for Kasdorf. 2:10 to go in the third. Up to 40 now. A chance now for the Crimson walking in. Save made, tipped to the near side. Fanning on the shot, Anderson in the circle now. Horton played below the goal line. Seb Loy turning to the far side. He's wrapped up by Hampton, gets away. Loy driving in, poked away by Hampton. And now Schrader near side for Bourbonnais. Bourbonnais trying to get to the puck, he will. Near side circle, walking in. His shot was blocked by Bergen, who did a good job to recover after he had a step on him in the offensive zone.
Yeah, Bergen had really, really good positioning on Bourbonnais. Bourbonnais had nothing. He couldn't do anything but take the shot, and he had a weird angle on the shot. Actually, that mini break occurred because Bourbonnais actually missed the pass. He let it go through his legs, and he turned on the afterburners and got the puck. 1:45 left to play in the third, no score.
Getting down to the end of this one here. Race for the puck. Chris Colo's going to beat out the icing call. Chris Colo, watched by Reno. Hands it off there for Vesey. Turning is Moy. Knocked away from him. Wood knocks it free, then runs over Moy. Puck behind the RPI goal. Neatly near side for Wilson. To center now for Miller. Back ahead for Wilson. Lost it in his skates. Picked up by Wood. Fed on further. Here's Babella. Drop pass Melanson. Save made by Manson. All alone in front was Melanson. And he was denied by Merrick Manson. Some Madsen on Melanson action. Now behind the goal, Miller looking to jam it in. Still loose at the side of the cage, and now we get a whistle. 58.3 left in regulation time. We are still scoreless.
Yeah, Miloš Bubela getting open and finding Drew Melanson point blank and quick by Merrick Madsen with the pad save. Everybody in front of us threw up their hands like RPI finally scored a goal. But Merrick Madsen said, hey, sit back down. It's not to be. 58.3 left to play in regulation. RPI and Harvard scoreless.
Madsen trying to go six straight periods without allowing a goal to the Engineers. Puck loose near side of the Harvard zone. All by himself is Floodstrand. He scoops it high in the air, hit the scoreboard. And that will draw another whistle.
That's the second time this weekend.
Yeah. Doesn't happen all that often. But we had one last night as well.
Faceoff just outside the zone. 53.1 seconds left in regulation. No score.
Draw here, near side of the neutral zone. Floodstrand up the wall. Fanning on it was Bradley. He likes to go after Esposito. Now Floodstrand jumps on the puck. He'll carry behind the goal. Looking to wrap it around. Far side Bergen lost it on the stick handle. Comes loose. Miller trying to clear the zone on the pass. Didn't do so. It's still loose in the slot. Finally swatted far side for Rodriguez. He'll chip it off the boards. Controlled now by Floodstrand, who backs up to his own zone. Watched by Liljegren. Still Floodstrand. Tried to pick his pocket. Kept in by Rodriguez, but only for a second as Donato takes it away. 20 seconds to go here in the third. Still no score. Esposito on the move. Little shimmy fake to get around Schrader. Lines up a slapper. Blocked by Bradley. Comes free to the near corner. Now Anderson at the near point. Through traffic, deflects wide of goal. Picked up by Prapavesas with five. Up the near boards, Liljegren tied up and knocked down by Anderson. It's underneath Anderson, and that is where the third period ends. No score here. Shots are 41-28. After three.
It's 41-28, but the majority of Harvard shots came in the first and second period as RPI really, really had the bulk of chances in that third period and for the tail end of the second. This game was heading into overtime, so free hockey for the fans here in attendance as Merrick Madsen and Jason Kasdorf really equaling one another's efforts, both coming up with some big saves. Merrick Madsen coming up with a huge save on Drew Melanson right with a minute left to play in the third period and to keep this game scoreless, as Drew Melanson was point blank. He got open on a feed from Milos Bubela, and Merrick Madsen was very quick with the pad save to keep it out of the net.
So we have a brief break here. Teams will change ends. Faceoffs, 40 to 35 Harvard. So RPI doing a better job in the draw department this weekend than it had been throughout much of the season early on.
And that contributes. RPI is really starting the offense. You mentioned the faceoff, Perry, and RPI winning the faceoff, but getting the bulk of the chances off of those faceoffs and doing a good job getting free, as Jason Kasdorf and Merrick Madsen will switch ends as they both equal to the task. If the first three periods were any indication, these next 5 minutes going to be a roller coaster for the fans here in attendance, and a very fun roller coaster, one that you won't find in any amusement park, that only the excitement of a sporting event can bring to you, especially if you have a rooting interest in the teams playing, as the people here in attendance at the Fieldhouse do, as well as the fans traveling from Boston and watching the Crimson. So, in for a treat for the next 5 minutes, and Jason Kasdorf, Merrick Madsen getting ready, skating around the crease, doing their warm-ups, getting some water, and looking very poised in the back of the net. RPI, especially Chris Bradley, doing a great job neutralizing Jimmy Vesey and Kyle Coscolo, basically for the entire game. Only for the first 10 minutes of the first period, those guys look like they can cause some trouble, but the RPI really shored up their defense on those two, and has been keeping Harvard off the board thus far.
Overtime underway. 5 minutes of action here. If we don't get a goal, Chris Colo, a shot and a save made by Kasdorf. Kerem's around to the near side corner, now to the far side. Jared Wilson over there to pick it up, helped on further by Bubela, out to center for Wood. Wood hands it off there for Melanson. Melanson to the offensive end, pulls it back. Tried to take a shot, it was blocked, and moved on out to center. Wilson will fire it right back in. Couple engineers need a touch up. They do. Here's Bergen, near side of his own zone, behind the goal for Anderson. Back to Bergen. He looks to break out near side. Down the middle, broken up by Bubela. He'll carry it back into the offensive end. Bubela, drop pass. Melanson looking to center, came free to center ice. Bradley hadn't quite entered the zone yet, so the engineers will need to back up again. On out to center. Shot in by Bradley. Prapavessis. Engineers have it neutralized. Here's Bourbonnais. He'll move it in near side and just scoop it into the corner. Bounces around behind the goal. Anderson takes a hit from Nanny. Esposito skips by Schrader. Moving out to center ice, Chris Colo. Backhanded far side into his own bench. That'll draw a whistle. You are listening to live coverage of RPI Hockey here. Ed DeGarry and Perry Lascaris, 3:53 to go in this overtime period in a scoreless game.
And the faceoff is nearer to the Harvard zone. The RPI attacking zone, so RPI will try to regroup and win the faceoff and get it in the zone.
Draw here, neutral ice. Nanny is tied up. Glove down and ahead by Bradley. Thrown right back to him, and now carried into the zone by Donato. He takes a hit by Bradley. Shot near side, Nanny ahead for Bourbonnais. Scoops it into Harvard territory. Sherman's going to track it down. Sherman. Stick handling near side, feeds it out to center ice. Carried on further by Esposito. Near side, drop pass, far side, one-timer, wide of the net. Donato did not catch it cleanly. And now it's controlled by Rodriguez. There's a loose glove out there. It's a crimson glove, it's Sherman's. To the RPI line. Fed on for Rodriguez, too far for him. This will be icing on the engineers. And we'll have a stoppage with a 3:11 to play in OT. No goals in this one.
And you thought the overtime period was going to be very exciting. Both teams looking a little winded out there for the overtime period, as this, the pace of the play has slowed down dramatically. But we're going to get a timeout here by Seth Appert, which allows his guys to take a change. A very smart timeout here by Coach, allowing his team to get fresh legs out there and to try to win this faceoff and quickly get a goal past Merrick Madsen, but they haven't done so yet, and Harvard hasn't gotten anything by Jason Kasdorf. that hasn't hit the post, I should say, for either team. Post, if you're just joining us, RPI has hit 4 posts, and Harvard has hit 2 posts, but neither team has found the back of the net. Both goalies coming up with huge saves. Merrick Madsen won at the tail end of the third, and Jason Kasdorf basically all game coming up with some huge saves, but none really spectacular in overtime. It just, there to cover up when they had to be. So,
yeah, not 2 minutes into this overtime period. And we'll have the stoppage here. Back to action in just a moment. The Engineers are back in action next weekend. They host Arizona State for a pair here at the Houston Fieldhouse. Draw coming in the RPI zone, near side. Babella. It'll be Babella up against Tyler Moy to take this faceoff. Harvard without Alexander Kerfoot, who was injured, as Ed mentioned earlier, last night in Schenectady. One back to the point now. Bergen gives it back to Chris Colo. Back to Bergen. Faked a shot. He'll elect to just play it off the boards down low. Moy looking to center. Vizi was open for a second. Couldn't find him. Now a drive to the net by Chris Colo is poked away by Babella. Reno trying to feed it out of there. Finds Wilson. Wilson to center for Babella. A little bit of space for Milos to work in the near circle. Pulls it back. Takes a shot. Stick saved by Madsen. Glove down behind the goal. Big pile up. Out of the scrum comes Bergen. Long outlet pass behind Vizi. He's offside now. And we have an icing call. Pick your poison. 2:37 left in OT. Still scoreless.
Yeah, Vizi was offsides. And he couldn't touch the puck, which resulted in the icing. And the puck is going to come all the way back into the Harvard zone. So RPI needing to win a faceoff right here and put a quality shot on Madsen.
Crimson win it cleanly back for Anderson. They'll try the far side for Chris Colo. He's being hounded there by Miller. Knocked down. Played up the wall. Let it run for Liljegren. Liljegren to the circle. Shot coming. Glove save Madsen. And he'll cover up the rebound.
Yeah, he had Melanson crashing the net, and he just decided to cover it up before anything happened. Madsen doing a good job slowing it down and covering it up. Actually, that correction, that was Miller coming in, crashing the net. 2:24 left to play in overtime, no score.
Shots are 3-0 RPI here in OT. 41-31 overall for the Crimson. Shot through the middle of the ice, tipped at center. No icing here as Bradley's going to have to play up the far boards. Fed along for Liljegren. He's had a solid game here for the Engineers, creating some scoring chances. Rodriguez ties his man up in the far corner. Rodriguez trying to jump on it, plays it back to Miller. Miller, a slap shot. Comes free to the near side, half wall for Prapavesis. Prapavesis down low for Liljegren. Victor Liljegren from Stockholm, Sweden. Centering for Miller, a shot right on. And a save by Madsen. The Engineers looking to fire here in this third period in overtime. And they kind of turned the tables in that department.
And that's what you have to do. You have to keep putting the shots in on Madsen. Yeah, Madsen's a great goaltender, but you got to think, if you keep shooting, minute 51 seconds, one might go into the back of the net. They're doing a great job keeping Harvard out of their own zone and putting shots past Madsen, but Madsen has been equal to the task.
1:51 left in OT. Schrader on the draw. On the near side, face-off in Harvard territory. Bergen steals it away and shoots it off the glass. Trying to knock it out of the air was Reno, and he did. Loose puck right in front of the RPI bench. Bourbonnais flips it in deep. Anderson, the first one to it for Harvard. Gets partially hit there by Bourbonnais. Centering pass for Nanny was on his backhand. He did his best to try and get a piece of it, but not enough. Shot through center, broken up by Moy. Played back in the Engineers' control. They go D-to-D in their own zone. Reno for Wilson. He'll cross center and ring it in. Around to the near corner it goes. 1:17 left in overtime. Down low, Bourbonnais looking to center. Nanny knocked away. Never got to him. The intended target there. Vizi along the near wall. He nearly gave it away. Poked out to center ice. Chris Colo ties up with Bradley. Shot near side for Wood. Wood with some room. Has Bourbonnais with him. What a shot, looking for the far post. And it was blocked away by Madsen. To the point and out to center. Vizi has it knocked away from him by Bradley. Playing without a stick again is Wood. He's on number 3. Unless he found his first one. And now it's back into RPI territory. Near side pass for Prapavesis. Harvard putting the pressure on. Puck up the wall for Wood. Woodall just trying to get it in deep and does. 38 seconds to go in OT. Stopped there by Madsen. Sherman, far side, poked at and played in the far circle now. Digging for it is Melanson. Floodstrand ahead. Harvard can break here, 3-on-2 if they hurry. Far side, Esposito pulls it back. Fed to the near side. Sherman a shot. Saved by Kasdorf. Floodstrand again in the corner. Centering pass knocked away from VZ. And now Melanson with 13 seconds to go in overtime. Glove down by Sherman. He takes a hit from Babella up high. Played up the wall. On for Melanson. Trying to drop it off for Wood. 4 seconds to go. Wood gets hit in the corner with one, and that will do it. A scoreless tie here in this one. Scoreless ties seem to be all the rage this year in ECAC hockey.
Well, this was, for a scoreless tie, this was not a boring game. But usually scoreless ties are a boring defensive struggle, you know, neutral zone trap. Not this one. This was end-to-end. Both teams really, they earned this tie. I mean, yeah, they didn't put any in the back of the net, but both teams really earned this tie. And RPI defense doing a great job neutralizing Jimmy Vesey, Moy, and Criscolo, that line. And then, you know, Jason Kasdorf and Merrick Madsen, not too much that we can say about them. Just putting on a goaltender clinic here for both teams. Jason Kasdorf really only having to make one save in that overtime period, but it was a big one with about 15 seconds left to go in overtime. Point blank, he made the save on Harvard, and Merrick Madsen coming up huge for the tail end of the second period all the way through the rest of this game as the fans give a great cheer. This was a great tie. You mentioned yesterday coming in against Dartmouth, tough loss against a team they should have beaten, but a great tie here against Harvard. Maybe they should have even beat Harvard here tonight, but you know they didn't have a puck luck for four times. RPI hit the post, and two times Harvard hit the post, and we could be looking at a different game. But give credit to Jason Kasdorf and Merrick Madsen, two of the best goaltenders certainly in ECAC, if not the country. Playing here tonight, and both living up to their own billing.
Yeah, it was a big day for Kasdorf, who came back from injury. He last played in November 6th against Clarkson. He was knocked out of that game. He was able to come in here and make, I believe, 43 saves in the end to pick up the shutout for RPI. A solid chance there. So really, it's you'd like to pick up the win. You hit the post four times, but seeming this game could have gone either way. And at the end of the day, it's a point. And one RPI, you know, at the end of the year might look and say, all right, this is the point we have in the bank here.
Yeah, you know, and 1 point weekend is better than no point weekend any day of the week. So yeah, I'm sure Seth Thapper has to be pleased with the effort today. For RPI, really skating with the Crimson, the eighth-ranked team in the country. RPI proving they can skate with anybody here in the country from the field house. And, you know, just not lucky enough to put the puck in the back of the net, getting robbed by the post a few times. But, you know, not too much to say. Both teams really, really, really put on a great show, and fans got their money's worth here tonight, so. Perry, I guess you're running down the scoring for us?
Yeah, I'll do that.
So
done. Offensive.